that we weren't allowed. Danny, just so I'm clear, this first segment will still go on our YouTube channel, right? Like, we're still recording it and can upload it, or no?
No, because the whole thing is connected, the recorder
and the
live stream. But we are live right now.
So we're not going to have any series recap of Vanderbilt on our YouTube.
I mean, we usually don't, because baseball doesn't do good numbers on YouTube.
Okay. Oh, well, the audio will be up there. By the way, and we should be pushing this harder, and it's my pinned tweet right now, but we should all be pushing it harder. We now have off-the-bench specific – can you turn it down a little bit, Mario? We now have off-the-bench specific OTB feeds on Apple and Spotify. So no more going through the entire station, no more climbing through, you know, other shows or whatever. Like, whatever show you want now has their own feed. I don't think we've ever been on Spotify either, which is, like, insane. Shout out Jay Parker for finally making it happen. So we have our own RSS feed. So subscribe. Please spread the word. Again, if you go to my Twitter, it is the pinned tweet. I'm probably going to change the tweet because I was in a mood that day and I mentioned making Rule 34 OTB. There's no need for that. None of y'all need to do that. All you need to do.
It's also pinned on OTB.
And it's also pinned. Okay, yeah, I should definitely change it. But no, that's fine.
OTB has its own separate.
Okay, tweet. Perfect. So, yes. Or you can go to the OTB page that Danny does such an incredible job with. And go ahead and follow there so you can, because a lot of y'all been hitting me up like, hey, wait, where's the feed? Has an update or whatever? No, we have our own off the bench specific feeds now. Let's continue to talk baseball as, again, greatest week ever. Obi-Wan, Top Gun 2, Stranger Things, and college baseball tournaments. That's right, man. Look, the regular season for baseball, super fun. And in fact, I would argue that in a lot of ways, the college baseball regular season is superior to that of the MLB regular season because it's so much easier to digest and keep track of, right? Like, you know the rhythm. It's going to be 30 conference games.
Yeah.
It's going to be great, intense three-game series every weekend. You can watch all the standings rise and fall. I mean, this year we've seen LSU bounce back and forth all over the place. And so it's a fantastic experience, the regular season is. But why do you do it? Just like anything else, you do it to set yourself up for the postseason. And so in sweeping Vanderbilt this weekend, not only is that great for pride and hosting and everything else, but you are now a top four seed in this SEC as Auburn, man, drops to Kentucky. The 12-18 Kentucky Wildcats, who at times this year have just pulled some series out of thin air, they do so again, this time to LSU's benefit. And with the incredible comeback on Saturday, LSU now gets that, that coveted double bye, as they will not play until Wednesday, and they will play the winner of Kentucky and Auburn, who will run it back. Also, don't look now, but in this bracket, if you can manage to beat that winner, Tennessee is going to play the winner of Ole Miss and Vandy. And then I have to imagine that, well, Tennessee will likely win that. And so if LSU does, who are you going to get a shot at? The Volunteers. So it looks like this could be just a setting up for maybe a potential revenge play. We will see. But either way, the postseason is here.
Want the opportunity to win a couple games, but really play against Tennessee. Right? The team that you lost to last year, obviously, they had your number. They've been the number one team for a long time, not wire to wire. They started out in the teens, but for a long time. They've been the number one team in the country. I'd love to see you, if you get some of your bodies back, if you get Cade Doty, if you get Jacob Berry, that lineup, I'd like to see what they could do against the number one team in the country.
Absolutely. I would as well. And you know, there's a good chance that it could be happening. Before we talk about hosting, let's look at this SEC, because the final standings are pretty wild. I think something that jumps off the page is obvious, in that Tennessee at 25-5, that is an absurd conference record. Like, that's a conference record that I didn't think you would see in college baseball anymore, simply because it felt like there were too many powers in the SEC. It felt like it had become too democratized, right? This wasn't like when LSU was just vastly ahead of the curve in the Skip Bertman era. Like, I felt like there was too much money and too many good players, too many good teams to go 25-5, and yet here we are. But the other interesting takeaway, Jake, is that partially that could have been due to a weaker East. And I don't mean to take away from Tennessee, because, again, it blows my mind. But The East is surprising. I mean, Florida finishes second at 15-15.
Yeah.
UGA 15-15. You sweeping Vanderbilt has the Commodores with a losing conference record at 14-16. And so the East overall ends up being pretty weak. And then to keep the surprises going in the West, it is the team that we clowned the most entering the season, Texas A&M, who finishes on top. The Aggies go 19-11 in conference to win the West. Arkansas falling off the pace late, finishing 18-12, and then LSU right behind them at 17-13.
Tennessee, I will say, so Tennessee, great baseball team, but something that I did notice when I saw the overall standings, I'm like, you know what, Tennessee missed out on A&M, who finished first in the West. They missed out on Arkansas, who finished second in the West, and they missed out on LSU, who finished third in the West. Look, Tennessee, again, great baseball team. Who knows what would have happened? They could have won all those series. But they did have the opportunity to miss the three teams in the West that were at the top. In the East, as you mentioned, T-Bob, didn't have another team that had a winning record.
And so, look, I want a shot at the champs, certainly do. But to go back to the A&M thing, Jake, I can't help but be reminded of the show that we did in walk-ons, SEC opening weekend, and we're talking to Ben McDonald, we're talking to everybody. And at that point, A&M in non-conference play was batting like 200, and they did not have a good record. A&M was supposed to be a joke. It just shows you what an odd game baseball can be and why you can't give up like LSU did not on Saturday, why you have to keep pushing. Because Texas A&M was supposed to be bad. They were supposed to finish last. And then, you know, they come out, they beat LSU. Oh, that's a bit surprising. Also, by the way, looking back, how important now does that Sunday A&M game feel, right? Showing the value of why you have to fight no matter what. Even on a weekend in which you've lost, you have to try to find a way to win game number three. I mean, I keep thinking about that throwing error to first where Trey Morgan slides and fields it and throws it to second and gets them out, ends up getting you that win. And now that win ends up pushing you into the four seed, into the double bye. But for A&M, yeah, I mean, it's like you kept expecting them to fall off the pace. You kept expecting them to come back down to earth, and they did not. So credit to them, winners of the West this year. And now, as far as LSU hosting goes, Jake, I don't know if I am – well, I guess I would say this. I don't know. I'm not like talking to like NCAA insiders, anything like that. I do think though, with the schedule that LSU faced, combined with going 17-13 in the SEC, and then maybe the biggest factor, the factor that it's LSU, and you run an NCAA tournament to make money to sell tickets, right? And so if you have two teams that are relatively equal, and you may not like this as a fan, but in this case, it works out for you because you are a fan of a big brand. If things are relatively equal, you are going to put your thumb on the scale for the town that will respond better to hosting a regional. And Baton Rouge will pack out a regional. I don't even know that I think they have to win a game next week to end up being a host. We will see. If they win a game, I think it's guaranteed. If you win a game in this week's SEC tournament, it is guaranteed. But, yeah, I think you've likely already locked up a host spot.
Well, I think the latest D1 baseball projections had them going to Hattiesburg.
Yeah, I saw that.
In the Southern Miss regional. That seems crazy.
That seems really
Southern
stupid.
Miss was a team that was in the top seven for a long time this year. I mean, they were up there. They were playing really good baseball. They have since come back to earth. They've been in the teens over the last couple of weeks, still playing good baseball, but not playing that great brand that you have to play when you're a mid-major. So I've got to imagine LSU and Southern Miss are pretty close to each other as far as maybe some of the resume. Now, obviously, Southern Miss's conference isn't going to hold up to what LSU plays in, but I'm with you. I would have a hard time believing that they would send LSU to Hattiesburg. Southern Miss in the RPI, I do understand. They just jumped back nine spots, so they do sit 13th in the RPI. LSU is 23rd there, but if it's remotely close, I have to believe, because of the things that you just laid out there, that Baton Rouge and LSU would host that regional.
Yeah, and I mean, you got to be one of the top 16 teams in the country. I think it's very easy to form an RPI.
Again, RPI doesn't necessarily, like, because LSU's 23rd right now, that does not mean they aren't a top 16.
Vanderbilt's like 6th or 7th.
They're 5th,
okay,
I think.
Okay,
they were 3rd last. They only dropped down two spots after getting swept.
Okay, so they're 5th
yeah.
in RPI. They ain't going to get the 5 seed.
Right.
You're 14 and 16. RPI is not where you end up being ranked. It's just a metric in that equation. And LSU's RPI is fine. They jumped it up heavily this last week with the Northwest State win and the sweep. And yes, again, they want a Baton Rouge regional. Why would they not? It's going to be packed out. It's going to be a ton of fun. So I think they're hosting. I think if they win Wednesday, certainly they will host. But I'm excited to watch from here on out. I'm also excited to get a look at Jay Johnson in his first playoffs, right? Or first kind of postseason action. Does he manage it differently? How will he manage it? And oddly enough, Jake, in an SEC tournament setting where the timing of everything is weird in terms of pitching, LSU's mishmash approach may actually be a bit of an advantage. And that they have a ton of guys that can come in and give you innings because they've been doing it all year long. They don't have a starter that they've had to overly rely on that can't be ready because he's on short rest. Like, it doesn't matter. Like, they have the arms ready to go, and they've thrown so many different arms that what's a new setup on Wednesday? It doesn't mean anything. It's what you've been doing all year long.
You've been piecing together everything, and everybody's kind of been ready to go. And, like, in game one against Vanderbilt, like, you probably didn't have Raiselman going for 3 2/3. Like, that's not really something he's done, but he did it in that game because he had to, right? You can look at what we saw on Saturday. Doesn't have it. Well, it's got to be, you know, all the parts, like everything that you possibly can have. Jacob Hasty. I mean, Ty Floyd. Ty Floyd's like a perfect example of someone that 2 weeks ago we're wondering, like, is he still on the roster? You're like, where is he at? He started the season as the Saturday starter. Well, he works on some things. Jay Johnson said, like, he's been working to get back. There was a couple of things that he needed to work on. Well, he's worked on them, and he's been really, really good. Even against Ole Miss in the series they got swept, he was, like, the one bright spot from the mound.
Yeah.
He gave you 6 really good innings. Well, he gives you 5 innings. He strikes out 7, only gives up 1 earned run on game 2 of this Vanderbilt series. So that's somebody that didn't really pitch for a long time.
He's now a weekend starter.
But he stayed ready. Yeah. Right, and he worked on things, and when it was his time, he came in. So, look, you're fortunate you get the bye, so you don't have to play there. And also, the second part of that, not only getting the single bye there, but now it's your double elimination, like where you're at. So you can lose, and then the loser of game 8 obviously would go up, and you would play the loser of game 7. So that would be A&M in either Florida or South Carolina. So, like, yes, the bye is great. You get an extra day of rest, and with your arms, and you had to use some, that will help you. But also just the double elimination part of that, obviously, is kind of the second part of that.
Especially if you still do need one win to get to the SEC. You just need to get 1 of 2. That's beyond doable for this LSU team. So great job, Tigers. Way to go, dude. All right, when we get back, Jeff Duggan had a pretty interesting article on the 2019 LSU football team that's a bit later. So keep it locked right here, Off the Bench.
Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob. In times of need, get a full list of phone numbers, websites, and other important emergency information on the Demco Stormwatch page at 1045ESPN.com.
There it is, the extra mile on the border of expected and extraordinary for those willing to go further, like vans customized for work or play. With safety and tech to keep you connected. Supported by a 5-star sales service and finance team. And backed by the 1-star you know. So go the extra mile. It's never crowded because so few have what it takes to go there. Mercedes-Benz vans.
Join 100.7 The Tiger and Our Lady of the Lake Ascension Saturday, June 25th at the Lamar Dixon Expo Center in Gonzales.
Enjoy live music from Tet Dur, Mike Broussard and the Night Train, and Jamie Badron and the Kickin' Cajuns. Make sure you grab a delicious plate of jambalaya from the Mike Ward's Liberty Safe's Jambalaya Cook-Off to raise money for the Alzheimer's services of the capital area.
The Swamp Pop Music Festival with Supreme Chevrolet.
Louisiana's Country Station.
100.7 The Tiger.
I've been doing business with Luber for 25 years. They're dependable, trustworthy. It's just the attention to detail with our clients.
Our folks have years and years of experience. They're highly trained professionals. But many companies have that asset. What I'd like to think makes Luber a bit different is that we use those talents in a way that truly is dedicated to serving the needs of the folks who depend on us.
Crime has serious consequences, but anyone can make a mistake. If you find yourself in trouble with the law, know that you have rights, and it's okay to demand them. The law offices of O.C. Brown are here to protect you and your rights. Felony or misdemeanor, DUI or drug charge, no matter what crime you're accused of, you still have rights. Let the law offices of O.C. Brown uphold them. Call 225-343-1111, your law firm for a lifetime.
It's no secret. The best oysters in Baton Rouge are at Jolie Pearl Oyster Bar. Enjoy mouth-watering South Louisiana flavor and oysters from all over the country. And don't forget our nightly drink specials. Jolie Pearl Oyster Bar, located in downtown Baton Rouge.
Eli's always been into grilling. It took us a while to see it, but the signs were there.
What are you doing, Eli?
I knew grilling was my thing. I have been talking about it throughout my career.
Happy with the results?
I am. Got the new grill from barbecueguys.com. It performed great.
My advice, as I always told my boys,
do more of what you're born to do.
Barbecue Guys, for those who are born to grill.
You want cheese on your burger, Pops?
I'll take a little cheese.
Week's presto. You're speaking another language, like magic.
I love that Babbel's lessons aren't just robots talking. They're voiced by native speakers, so you get the pronunciation just right.
If you want to learn a language, there's no faster, easier, better way than
Babbel.
Babbel.
Babbel. Go to Babbel.com to try for free. That's BABBEL.com. Babbel.com.
Join me, Ronnie Rance, every Saturday morning from 10 until noon for Sports Shorts Radio presented by La Bears Casino, where we'll have breakfast sandwich reviews, and you never know what Joel Davis is going to say right here on 104.5 ESPN Baton Rouge.
Monday edition of Hunt and Hill. Get the recap from LSU and Vanderbilt. Where's LSU's NCAA tournament resume? And we'll get you ready for Hoover. Hunt and Hill, noon to two weekdays on 104.5 ESPN, Baton Rouge.
All-Star Toyota presents Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob, the 2022 LAB Prestige Award winner for Best Sports Radio Show, ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria, and 1130 The Tiger.
What's going on, y'all? Welcome back. OTB. Somebody call Admiral Iceman. Very interested to see what Val Kilmer's role is going to be in this new one. You see his picture.
Yeah.
They mentioned him being an admiral.
Yep.
I imagine, you know, Maverick got kicked out or something and he's been off doing his own thing, whereas Iceman fell into the military hierarchy and worked his way up. But Iceman, having experienced Maverick's potential firsthand, knows there's only one man for the job.
And he knows that he's got to do it his own way. Hell, it's the only way that Maverick can do it. It's his process, and his process isn't orthodox, but...
Yeah.
It works.
It does work. It's interesting. A little bit of life imitating art, right? We talk about Tom Cruise, and look, yes, we all know Scientology, whatever. Like, I get it as well. But Cruise is a beast actor, and talk about doing it your own way. He very much is a Maverick style actor, and we showed the video last week of him making them do all of that real ass flight training. No green screens allowed. When it comes to Tom, though, I looked it up. They were not allowed to fly. What was it? The F-18 or F-14? Like whatever the most modern military jets are.
Yeah.
Whatever the most modern ones are. It's either F-18 or F-19. They actually were not allowed to fly those. Unfortunately, but I can't wait. But do you think we see Val Kilmer on screen? Because he's obviously had a horrible battle with, I believe it's throat cancer. But if you've seen interviews from the past few years, it has just been devastating, and he can kind of barely talk, and They filmed this years ago when he was in a low spot. So I wonder what his actual on-screen capabilities are going to be like. So you think we do see him on screen?
I do.
I think I do as well, though. I don't know that we've seen any footage during the
No, we have not.
During the preview cycle.
Well, that's probably on purpose.
I can't wait. I would love
Did
to
you,
see.
By Falcon. The way,
I mean,
speaking
Iceman
of Val,
was my favorite character in the original Top Gun.
Yeah, I get that. Have you finished Tombstone? Speaking of Val Kilmer,
I have still not finished Tombstone.
Okay,
I got I've gotten a bit distracted with other television shows. I started watching Love on the Spectrum US last night, which is fantastic. I also Our Flag Means Death, which again I'm not going to tell everybody to like go out and watch it, but I'm enjoying it. It's very funny. It's Blackbeard and Taika Waititi and the dude from like I said, a very New Zealand style of comedy there. What in terms of other things that I'm excited about today, man, it's just I can't get over Obi-Wan coming out later this week. You keep seeing all this that they're on a press tour right now. All these heartwarming stories about Hayden Christensen. Are you going to do any prep for Obi-Wan, or are you going to watch Obi-Wan with your children, Jake? Have you decided yet?
If they want to, yeah. I mean, certainly I will.
Well, but you didn't let you didn't let Jackson watch. What do you want to watch this weekend?
Yeah. So my 12-year-old, who look, he's a giant, but still, you're 12. Just because you look like you're 16 doesn't mean that you need to be doing this. He texted me on Friday. He's like, "Dad, do you think it'd be okay if I watched American Psycho?" I said, "No, son. I wouldn't let your mom watch American Psycho. You're not watching American Psycho." And then he hit me with another one. I forget which one it was.
We'll go back. We're going to break. We'll go back and we'll actually just read the text verbatim because it is just a pure gold text exchange here. Also, talk a little LSU softball on the other side of this. Keep it locked here on OTB.
Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob.
Go to centralplumbing.org, 925-8552, centralplumbing.org. If you're a do-it-yourselfer, you can go into the showroom and they have all the pieces that you could possibly need to plumb yourself. But plumbing can be very complicated, okay? So don't worry about that. Just call up 925-8552, go to centralplumbing.org. I don't care if it's a weekend, weekday, holiday. They got 24/7 emergency service. Set up that time for them to come out to your home and then have your plumbing needs met. You don't lift a finger. You got flat rate pricing. You got excellent warranty coverage. And, of course, everybody's licensed, bonded, and insured.
225-925-8552, 24/7 emergency services. Centralplumbing.org is the website. If you're looking to remodel, that's your business or your home, commercial or residential, they can do it for you. They've got the full fleet available. They can handle any job. They're going to come in, give you a consultation, tell you exactly what they would do in your space to make it better, and then they'll make it better. Centralplumbing.org.
Our listeners fire off their opinions on the JimsFirearms.net hotline at 499-1045. Keep listening for your next chance to shoot us your thoughts with the JimsFirearms.net hotline on 1045 ESPN Baton Rouge.
Come on over to Corvall Toyota to pre-order your next vehicle. It's an easy and stress-free process. Browse, reserve, pick up, and enjoy. It's that simple. So come on down to Happy Town. That's Corvall Toyota in Opelousas, Happy Town, USA.
The 2022 Smoke 'Em If You Got 'Em, presented by Mockler Beverage, is almost here. Smoke 'Em If You Got 'Em is an event that raises money to support military veterans and their families. Tickets are $100, and this year's event benefits the Special Forces Charitable Trust. Come enjoy live music, a grill station, a cigar station, a dessert station, a live and silent auction, and so much more. It's the 2022 Smoke 'Em If You Got 'Em fundraiser, presented by Mockler Beverage, Sunday, May 22nd at Ben 77. Learn more at smokeembr.com.
Dad! Dad!
Kids have staked out their place at Ochsner Medical Complex, The Grove, where more than 30 pediatricians and pediatric specialists are all conveniently located under one roof, so you can spend less time driving and more time keeping your kids well.
Dibs!
It's no wonder kids call dibs at The Grove. Ochsner Health Center for Children.
Gulf Coast Bank and Trust is giving our customers the power to bank anywhere, anytime during this challenging event. And we're right there with you. Our mobile banking app is a smart way to manage your money and time. Gulf Coast Bank and Trust, the bank that cares about you.
And this year, 2022, it's time to finally treat yourself. Bring your boat to the next level with front-to-back boat service. You want the latest and greatest marine technology? You want to go to the place that has not one, but two NMEA certified techs. Family owned and operated by the Sherman family for 30 years, Front to Back is the answer in Baton Rouge for all of your custom boat needs. So head to fronttobackboatservice.com or find them on Facebook, Front to Back Boat Service.
Visit Acura of Baton Rouge for attractive offers on the MDX.
If you're in an accident, a car accident, a slip and fall where you're injured, you need to call an attorney. The defendant insurance company, it's their goal to close the case as quickly as possible and pay out the least amount of money as possible. That's why it's important to call an attorney and call the law offices of O.C. Brown.
At the Law Office of O.C. Brown, we're a family-owned firm. We want to be your law firm for a lifetime.
For a Monday edition of Early Line, as we recap the sports weekend, including both conference finals in the NBA and the rest of LSU baseball series against Vanderbilt. Join us from 2 to 3 p.m., 104.5 ESPN Baton Rouge.
All-Star Toyota presents Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob, ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria, and 1130 The Tiger.
Is this Huey Lewis?
Yep. Huey Lewis and the News.
It's all Jackson wanted to watch,
great,
dude.
Great.
You don't like Christian Bale?
I love Christian Bale.
Wow. Okay.
He probably sees him as Batman. You know, so I get this.
Good. If Batman actually, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
Was willing to do what it takes instead of having some weird relationship with all of his criminals where he just continues to allow them to kill people.
Yeah, you're right. Shout out Jared Leto, by the way.
And that. What? You hate Batman now?
No, I have always liked Batman, but are we going to sit here and actually, you know what? Maybe the Spider-Man No Way Home movie argues against this best, what I'm about to say. But are we going to sit here and pretend like Batman is a well-adjusted human being? When you dive into Batman, the second you get beyond, ooh, dude, he's a badass. Look at that, dude. It starts to become like very, very questionable, right? He's obviously got insanely bad coping mechanisms. I think there's an added sadism to just, basically crushing petty criminals, like snapping femurs, arms, and everything. Or not even that. But with these supervillains refusing to kill them, but, you know, accepting the reality that they will likely return, escape, and kill more and more people. Like, how many lives would have been saved if Batman was willing to kill one? I'm just saying, he's got kids running around getting in gunfights with him. That he takes into his home. He has all the resources in the world. Robin just couldn't have been like a wealthy kid who had to make it through tragedy. They got to go to like a great school and everything. No, he had to go fight crime. Then he becomes Nightwing, moves to Bloodhaven. It's a whole
Anyways,
thing, Danny.
Like this whole argument, let's just move on from it because what are we doing here? Yo. So Jackson.
Danny asked a question. I'm just saying, dude.
Y'all can talk about this during the break.
Counter something, Danny, if you think you have any counters.
But my 12-year-old asked to watch American Psycho, and I'll read it. He said, can I watch American Psycho? I said, absolutely not. I wouldn't let your mom watch that. He said, would it matter if I said please? I said, it would not. He said, well, it's just like Daredevil, and you let me watch that. Like, Ben Affleck's Daredevil is not like
American. It was Ben Affleck's Daredevil. I assumed he was talking about the Netflix show.
I don't know which one he's talking about. I said, it's 1,000 times worse than that. He said, I'm mature. I can handle it. Then he goes, can I watch Breaking Bad? I said, absolutely not. He hits me with it's educational.
I mean, he is a teacher.
You're 12 years old.
He is a teacher, though.
Go watch G.I. Joe's or something.
Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob.
He's a teacher, dude. I mean, I don't know. It is educational. Go to rejuvememedical.com. Restore me, refuel me, rejuve me. Rejuvememedical.com. You want to feel younger, better, stronger. 40, 50, 60, 70, 30, 20. Male, female, I don't care. The point is, if you just want to feel better than you feel now, you want to go to Rejuve Me and get a plan, a customized, comprehensive plan for you. And maybe that's something like HRT, hormone replacement therapy. Maybe it's not. It's not one size fits all. Try your labs, meet with a lifestyle specialist, and again, a customized plan for you and your specific needs.
RejuveMeMedical.com is the website. Consultation right there in the top right corner of the website, because remember, you can have three people the same age. You're all going to have different needs, and you won't know what those needs are until you get the consultation set up. Or you pick up the phone. You can do it this way, 225-230-4201. Again, also, RejuveMeMedical.com.
Gulf Coast Office Products is a nationally recognized Savin office equipment dealer based right here in Louisiana. Over 100 employees strong, Gulf Coast has the boots on the ground to support all vertical markets from education, engineering, legal, and finance. With the latest in office technology from desktop to production segment units, Gulf Coast and Savin have the perfect fit for you. Call 225-756-2644. That's 756-2644 for Gulf Coast Office Products.
Service Mastery Elite create clean, disinfected work environments. As a local business, we take pride in serving the New Orleans and Baton Rouge areas. Our cleaning protocols follow CDC and OSHA standards for healthcare settings, offices, senior living, restaurants, and industrial plants. Contact Service Mastery Elite to get your operation ready for reopening with germ disinfection cleaning. Service Mastery Elite, the trusted choice in professional cleaning since 1996.
At All-Star Toyota, you get it all. If you're in the market for an all-new Toyota vehicle, come see our friendly and knowledgeable sales team at All-Star Toyota. Located in Baton Rouge at the corner of Airline and Goodwood, we've been serving our community since 2005 by offering a large selection of new Toyota cars, trucks, and SUVs. Get behind the wheel of your dream car and take a test drive at All-Star Toyota today.
This is a house call. This is a follow-up appointment. This is a diabetes checkup. This isn't just more convenient care, it's more advanced care. This is innovating healthcare at Louisiana's number one hospital, Ochsner.
I've been doing business with Luba for 25 years. They're dependable, trustworthy. It's just the attention to detail with our clients.
Our folks have years and years of experience. They're highly trained professionals, but many companies have that asset. What I'd like to think makes Luba a bit different is that we use those talents in a way that truly is dedicated to serving the needs of the folks who depend on us.
Crime has serious consequences, but anyone can make a mistake. If you find yourself in trouble with the law, know that you have rights, and it's okay to demand them. The law offices of O.C. Brown are here to protect you and your rights. Felony or misdemeanor, DUI or drug charge, no matter what crime you're accused of, you still have rights. Let the law offices of O.C. Brown uphold them. Call 225-343-1111, your law firm for a lifetime.
It's no secret, the best oysters in Baton Rouge are at Jolie Pearl Oyster Bar. Enjoy mouth-watering South Louisiana flavor and oysters from all over the country.
Good morning. It's 8 a.m. on Monday, May 23rd. Today in Baton Rouge, expect to see cloudy skies with a high of 84. If you missed hour one of the show, you can now catch that up at the on-demand section at 1045ESPN.com. Coming up on OTB, we have a new edition of Weekend Winners coming up next, and Hold the Mayo joins the show at 9:15 for Spread Lines. You can follow us on Twitter, Instagram, and TikTok at OTB underscore ESPN. or you can watch us on YouTube at the 104.5 ESPN channel and subscribe for daily content. Hour number two of Off the Bench, live from the Mercedes-Benz Baton Rouge Studios, starts now. Let's go!
All-Star Toyota presents Off the Bench with Jacob Hester and T-Bob Hebert.
Yeah!
Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob.
Hey, they said I gotta come off the bench.
All-Star Toyota presents Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob. Yo.
What's going on, y'all? Welcome back to OTB. Hour number two kicking off right now. Hope you are having a wonderful weekend there. Very excited here on Off the Bench. Big week coming up all week long. Many of y'all mad at me about the Batman takes. Look, I agree. Let's just all enjoy Batman at the surface level. He's fun. He's badass. He has gadgets. He fights crime. It's all very cool. And Jake, what do you think the actual chances are that Jax is going to respect the ruling and not watch American Psycho?
I will go into his room when he's not home, and he's not smart enough. Well, he is smart. That's kind of the problem. He's too lazy to cover up and watch, like on the like previous watch or
yeah,
whatever.
Yeah,
he's
no, got, I know what I'm saying. It's all digitally tracked.
Yeah,
now.
He's got like my Apple login.
Of course.
Okay, so I can see it. He's got my HBO Max. Probably somehow. So I've got that as well. I can go back and find it.
It's fair. But what if you watch it at a friend's house? You know, I was never allowed to watch The Simpsons. You best believe when I was at a friend's house, that TV was on The Simpsons.
He's the constantly. Kid who wants people to come to his house.
Okay.
He doesn't want to go to other people's house.
Okay.
So.
Okay. Well, we will see. Get your bets in now.
Here's
will
the deal.
Jackson watch American
Here's
Psycho?
The deal.
I think there's a good chance he's going to find his way
I'm
to
I'm going
to
find a way to, like, not find like the popular meme scenes or the GIF scenes like everybody knows. I'm going to get like a deep cut scene from American Psycho and be like, hey, man, that scene was wild. And see if he.
Oh, like the, know, just like a casual that. Reference and see if he says anything about it. Yeah, it's not bad. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's I'm dealing with, I guess, the 4-year old version of that as my daughter has straight up Tommy Pickles her way into figuring out how to get the. Like the anti-child lock things off of their doors, right?
Oh, yeah.
She got a metal straw out the other day that she like basically keistered into bed with her, straight up prison style.
I was about to say, busted, she got contraband?
Yeah, she like busted that thing out like from under her pillow, wedged it in there, cracked him off. And then last night, my wife bought new ones and even went so far as taping them. Mm-mm. And was like, you know, Alice, you're not going to be able to get out of here. And she literally told my wife last night, she said, we'll see about that. And at 6:30 this morning, at 6:30 this morning, I got the text that we did see, and the 4-year-old won once again. I'm kind of proud of her. Like I said, it reminds me of Tommy Pickles. He always had that screwdriver in his diaper, and when the Pickles parents and all those parents, who I love, because they would basically just be like, "Screw these kids, we're going to party." They would just drop them in the little. Playpen and just goes go drink.
We're gonna go drink in the back.
Yeah, like hell yeah.
Grilling session going
like,
on back there.
They never have any idea what's going on.
No.
But Tommy used to bust out the screwdriver and break him out. Alice falling in Monsieur Pickel's footsteps. But look, it is hour two of OTB on a Monday, which means we begin with weekend winners.
That's how winning is done.
That's right. We can't have anyone freak out there, okay? Gotta keep our composure.
Smash mouth, right?
Got too far.
I'm by winning. I win here and I win there. Now what?
Are you doing what it takes to win a championship?
Wow, winning.
Well, then I guess there's only one thing left to do. What's that?
Win the whole thing.
I have no idea what's going on today's episode of Charmed, but it looks like they've been thrust into some sort of MTV Spring Break alternate reality as they are on the beach with some sort of Carson Daly lookalike, and Smash Mouth just played the beach stage.
Oh, Smash Mouth. What do you think Smash Mouth, like right now, currently, like what are they doing? Are
I
they
bet
hitting
you they're on
the,
tour somewhere.
The Biloxi Casino Tour?
Are they not above that? I feel like Smash Mouth is still pretty big, dude.
I mean,
like Smash Mouth could play Jazz Fest and nobody would bat an eye, right? Or am I wrong?
But the thing about those is, I mean, that's not like hating on those artists. It's just their time in the sun is maybe in the shade right now.
Yeah, that's fair.
Yeah. There's a lot of good artists.
And that's on their own accord, too. I feel like they...
I mean, Earth, Wind, and Fire, like...
If Earth, Wind, and Fire can do the Biloxi, yeah, then anybody you know what I mean? Can. I agree with that. That's fair.
I got to say, he's like coming to Biloxi, Mississippi now.
Shout out MTV Spring Break, too. I mean, who didn't love MTV Spring Break growing up, dude? It just looked like so much fun. It looked so cool. Shout out to Justin Thomas. You know, we don't like to give Alabama people credit on here, but if we're doing weekend winners, bro, if we're doing weekend winners on a weekend,
what?
You're the one that doesn't care about Alabama because we beat them so many times in college, right?
Why would you, though? Because you didn't.
Because I give credit where credit's due. This is why y'all can never say that I'm biased, because I am always correct, because I'm an objective scientist, okay? And the science says, coming back in a major, the PGA Championship, from being 7 strokes down on the final day to then winning, the sign says that is pretty badass. Yeah. In a playoff, in a 3-hole playoff, beating Zalatoris. Congratulations to this. What I love is this quote from Jim Bones McKay, a guy who used to be Mickelson's caddy to the tune of 5 majors. He was in the TV booth. He was done caddy. Justin Thomas brings back retirement Saturday night. You know what he told Thomas? Very simple here. But like a lot of simple things, a lot of power. And he told Thomas quite simply, quote, you have to stop being so hard on yourself. You don't have to be perfect. Keep staying positive and good stuff can happen. Look, I know that sounds dumb and easy and you know, like obvious, but Justin Thomas directly credited that quote after the tournament win as to something that he continued to return to on Sunday. And so as you go through your life this week, and maybe you're being overly judgmental of yourself, you're getting on yourself, remember what our boy Bones had to say. You don't have to, you know, you have to stop being so hard on yourself. You don't have to be perfect. Keep staying positive and good stuff can happen. Love it. Congrats, Justin Thomas. Weekend winner.
Sure. By the way, I looked it up. Collective Soul, Alan Jackson, Ron White, Daughtry, Vince Gill, Rick Springfield, Ted Nugent. All coming to Biloxi. Cheap Trick. Wayne Shepherd.
Yeah. You're absolutely right. He should be. Yes. They are completely appropriate to play the Biloxi circuit. Right. I agree.
Fair enough. My first weekend winner. And obviously we talked a lot of LSU baseball. So it's not like a LSU baseball just in general. My actual weekend winner is the LSU mentality that they had this weekend. You go on the road to Vanderbilt, who Jay Johnson said, the first time we heard from Jay Johnson as the LSU baseball coach, Vanderbilt is the standard. That's the standard that we have to get back to at LSU. He singled that team out. So you go on the road, you're playing against that team after getting swept by Ole Miss at home, and your mentality was, we're going to bring out the gold jerseys for all 3 games.
Yeah, how about that?
We are going to set a tone saying we are here, because now in this portion of the season, it's all about winning every single game. We've got to go out there and have that mentality. So you bust out the gold jerseys for 3 straight games on the road. In game one, everybody's like, oh, what are you doing? You got to set up for the series. You got to save your pitchers. What do we do? We got to lead. No. I'm going to send out Eric Raizelman. He's going to strike out 6 3⅔, not give up a hit, not give up a run, because we're winning every single game. We're going to trust our other guys to be able to win on Friday and Saturday. Because if you don't get game one, T-Bob, I don't know if you know this, you can't sweep if you don't get game one, okay? So we're going to get game one.
It's a great point, Jake.
And we don't want to save anything for game two and game three. So they choke them out in game one. Also, getting down 6 on Saturday to Vanderbilt, right? Okay, you've already won 2 games. Like T-Bob said, some of the casual viewers were like, okay, well, man, whew, man, great run.
I didn't change it, but I was saying, right, like, ah, you know.
You won, yeah, you won too. Okay, whatever. LSU didn't have that mentality. They cut it in half, all right? It's 6-3. And then when it gets to 8-4, you're like, oh, man, again. Oh, well, that's okay. You came back a little bit. They didn't allow that. They cut it to 8-7. Then it gets 9-7. And again, you're like, two runs, man, that run. Even though you got out of the bases loaded jam, it's still, I don't know. And you end up scoring over 20 runs in that game. The mentality that LSU baseball had this weekend is a championship level mentality, right? It's, we have to win every single game we play from here on out. That's why we're wearing the gold jerseys. Remember when they started that streak, when they won 20 something games in a row, it was a gold jersey streak. They've got that kind of mentality. And now you get a chance to get a bye in Hoover. You're double elimination at this point. And now you win a game. Maybe we're talking about postseason baseball in the box.
Yeah. Again, I think there's a very good chance, even if you would go 0-2 that you could get it, but obviously you win one, and I think you guarantee it. Mario, what you got?
My first weekend winner is Oreos. So Oreos got some good pub from Jermaine O'Neal over the weekend. Y'all remember Jermaine O'Neal? And I sent this in a group. So he was on the Knuckleheads podcast, and he was talking about how he played for the Heat right before LeBron and Chris Bosh signed with them. But towards the end of his career, right before they started winning championships, he chose not to re-sign with Miami, and he talked about why on the Knuckleheads podcast.
I'm going to be honest, Pat. I'm going to start with Miami. They wanted me to re-sign. Like, I knew LeBron and him was coming. And this is the realest thing I could tell y'all. You know, they got that 8% body fat for a big guy.
Yeah.
That's heavy lifting.
Mm-hmm.
I remember going into the pantry at night, looking at the Oreos looking at me. Right? And I could, bruh, I am in a full battle daily on what I ate. And I was like, bruh, I'm 30 plus years old. I can't go through this. So I was like, bruh, look, I'm too old to be having a debate whether I want to have an Oreo or not. Right? I can't do that. So that's why I left Miami.
I feel that, Jermaine. Feel that.
How about that, dude? Right there. How honest is that? My man just said, nah, straight up, D-Wade, Bosh, LeBron, they were too locked in. They were working too hard. I'm the tail end of my career. I'm not ring chasing. Like, he got a ring already with the Wade Shaq team, or no? It doesn't matter. No, it doesn't matter. He didn't. But he didn't care. He just wanted to eat those Oreos, man. That's incredibly relatable. Yeah. Shout out to Jermaine O'Neal. I wonder if that's like, I mean, it probably took him. Yeah, either way, that's as real. I agree with him. That is quite literally as real as it gets. I've never heard an athlete say, I didn't re-sign with that team because they were going to try so hard, Oreos. And I was just trying to chill and eat Oreos.
You have to admire his honesty, if anything.
Yeah, and it's not even like he was like, I'm done with the NBA.
Bro, you can eat Oreos and still play, though.
But it's crazy because Jermaine O'Neal was so good in that he was saying, like, I didn't want to be fully dedicated, but he's still in the league.
No, I get that.
That's crazy. He's that good. He's like, I didn't want to be fully dedicated, but I'm still in the NBA, whatever. Still making money.
Jimmy Butler doesn't eat Oreos.
No, Jimmy Butler would probably bite your kneecaps off if he caught you eating Oreos. Danny,
Oreos
what you got?
Are so good.
I guarantee you there's NBA players that eat Oreos.
No, I know. That's not the point, though. It's the point of accepting that, being good enough, too, that you can be a professional athlete without being this, like, you know, without being obsessively dedicated, where you're just like, you know.
And he talked about the 8% body fat. That's a rule that the Heat had, that you had to maintain it at 8%.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
I mean, that's a lot of teams have stuff like that.
Yeah, and he's just like, nah, I'm chilling, man. What you got, Danny? Yeah.
My weekend winner goes out to Andrew Wiggins putting Luka Doncic on a poster.
Oof. It was nasty. It was nasty.
Luka said, I wish I had those bunnies after the game.
Also, so I didn't watch the game. They called an offensive foul here, didn't they?
Yeah.
Jeez.
But it was still awesome.
Offensive fouls. I mean, charges are just the scourge of basketball. I don't know how. Why?
Because he
threw a forearm into him.
Yeah.
They're saying, shout out Andrew Wiggins, somebody who has resurrected his career in Golden State. And clearly the Warriors look like the best team in these playoffs. We'll get more on the playoffs in a little bit.
I think the Heat and Celtics is a series. Like, that's two really good teams going against each other.
The
Mavericks, a little bit of overachieving, getting there the way that they came back. And, like, they unlocked something in Luka and messed up, and he was able to will the team to victory there. But you look over in the East, like, I know what the Warriors are doing to the Mavericks, but I really don't think a lot of the Mavericks as a team. You look over in the East. Now, the question is going to be, does the East beat up on each other too much when Golden State's kind of cruising right now?
Yeah, I just in this era of the NBA, Golden State again looks like the premier version of this.
I'd love to see Golden State Miami.
It will be Golden State Miami. I do believe that. Like, I firmly believe the Heat are going to win this series. Like, but Jimmy Butler's going to be back, they said, right?
We don't know just yet. No confirmation.
Okay. My next weekend winner, I'd say Jordan Thompson again, man. I know that he caught a lot of flack over the year and a lot of it well-earned, but hit 467 of the week and played great defense. Came up with a massive hit in game three to take the 10-9 lead. That ended up being very safe, given what ended up happening. But either way, like, this entire team responding to adversity, sticking with it, honoring his coach's faith in him, Jordan Thompson. And then I would also say Gorilla Ball, a weekend winner. Again, 42 runs in this series, most ever given up by a Tim Corbin Vanderbilt team. Congratulations to the Bats. What you got, Jake?
Yeah, look, I do realize, like, Jordan Thompson, obviously, this is without questions, had some fielding issues during the season, but he's also somebody that's getting on base at over 400 right? I mean, he's 401 right now as far as on base percentage, and he's got 30 walks, 35 strikeouts. So it's almost right there even with each other. He's almost batted 300 in this year. He's got 6 home runs, 28 RBIs. Yes, the fielding has not been good. I completely understand that. But also, like, he is somebody that can give you some offensive production as well, and it does feels like it gets lost just a little bit there. So, Jordan Thompson, I agree with you. Like, for everything he's kind of had to deal with on the outside, I think he's been a really nice job of.
Yeah, you can throw Cruz and Joe Bear in the weekend winners as well. And Ty Floyd.
Yeah. There's a lot of weekend winners coming from LSU baseball. Real quick, I did want to mention the Premier League. As I put out there on Twitter, it was swerving like it was George Jones this weekend. I mean, it was absolutely bananas. It was the last day. Everybody plays at the same time. Man City and Liverpool are fighting for the championship. Man City's down 2 goals to Villa. It looks like they're going to blow it. Liverpool, all they had to do was score against your Wolves.
Yeah,
T-Bob, I'm sure you were watching it.
I was.
The game was
actually
tied.
No, unironically, it was on the television.
The game was tied, right? And then Liverpool scores, and Mo Salah thinks that they've won the Premier League.
Yeah.
And the crowd tells him, no. Actually, Man City scored 3 goals in 5 minutes. They're beating Villa right now. They're going to win the Premier League. And as an Evertonian, I love the fact that Liverpool didn't win the Premier League, obviously. And just great drama really throughout the day in the last day of the season. Tottenham gets a victory, so they get into Champions League. Arsenal falls just short. And also, Jesse Marsh, who's the coach of Leeds, is an American, right? And they don't. You know, American coaches over there, a lot of Ted Lasso jokes were thrown Jesse's way. He took this team over. They were going to get relegated. He finds a way. They fight back, and they score in extra time, like in the 92nd minute. They score to get themselves out of the relegation zone. They move from 18 to 17, and now they get to stay up in the Premier League with Jesse Marsh as their head coach because they scored a goal in the 92nd minute.
Damn.
It was bananas.
Damn.
Everybody rushes the field. It was great, great scenes all over the Premier League this weekend. The last day of the Premier League is one of my favorite sporting days of the year, and it didn't disappoint.
Do they rush the field this much? Because Man City rushed the field also.
Well, they won the Premier League, so Man City does.
Yeah.
Everton stayed up last week, so they rushed the field.
What I'm saying is this
Leeds,
like,
same situation.
Does this happen commonly in
for if you're in the relegation,
down a little bit,
if you're in, yeah, I'm yelling.
Jeez.
If you're in the relegation battle, right? You're in the relegation battle, and you're going to do that. And if you win the Premier League, you're going to do it.
Yeah, it's all over the place. All right, my next – or Mario, what you got?
My next weekend loser is the NBA award voters because Herb Jones should have at least made second team all defense. Like, Matisse Thybulle is in there. He's an okay player, but he wasn't even always in the rotation for the 76ers. And all of Herb Jones' stats are much better. He led all rookies in steals, 130, 50 more than the next closest rookie. Also played in 78 games, which is impressive in and of itself.
He led the Pelicans in minutes.
Yeah, and y'all saw the impact that's not even reflected in the stats that he made on the team. Like, the fact that he's not even on the second team, I think, is kind of a joke. So, loser, award voters.
And, like, multiple of these guys missed, like, 26, 25 games. Like,
Draymond only played in 46 games. I understand putting Draymond in there, but you do have to point that out.
It's just, you know what it is, honestly? It is a direct consequence of playing for who the Pelicans have been up to this time, which is a completely irrelevant franchise that people are not watching. Now, with that's why these playoffs are so important, right? Between the play-in and the playoffs, they made a statement to the national basketball audience and we are going to be good. People learned who Herb Jones was. They just learned too late. I don't think this will happen again to him, but yeah, you're right. He got job.
And weekend winner Trey Murphy, because he's like pining really hard for Herb Jones right now, which I think speaks to a good team dynamic, right? Like the first round rookie who didn't have quite as good of a season as a second round rookie still sticking up for him. And I remember this kind of thing used to happen. This kind of thing used to happen to Drew Holiday. Like, he would have really good stats, and he wouldn't make the all-defensive team. And you wouldn't see any teammates, like, stick up for him the way Trey Murphy's doing for Herb Jones. So that's kind of cool to see if you're a Pelicans fan.
Shout out to T-Murph. Danny, you got any more?
Yeah, Stranger Things fans.
We're finally here.
It's finally back. And it's been a long time coming.
Let's just go ahead and say nerds.
Yeah.
Like, nerds. Between Obi-Wan and Stranger Things, what a massive week. And even Top Gun. Like, nostalgic nerds, this is going to be an incredible week for all of us. I've already gotten like 5 or 6 text messages from friends being like, 5 days till Kenobi. Like, people are freaking out, dude.
I've gotten texts from people that have been like, so, like, can we, like, come watch Top Gun with y'all?
Yeah. No, and well, let's talk about it as a group, and then we'll decide what we want to do there.
Okay.
Because I've also had many of those as well.
As long as they're not as loud as the girls next to us.
Last time out.
Oh,
yeah,
my gosh. I was about to go full Nick Cage interview.
Okay, weekend loser. I hesitate to say this, okay, because I saw a Big Cat tweet over the weekend that I agree with. Anytime you say anything negative about the NBA, the NBA weirdos come out and they just like throw all kind of agendas on you and you get lumped into this crowd that I have no desire to be in. That said, the NBA playoffs are a loser right now. There's not a close game. There hasn't been a close game in like 2 weeks. And even in a Heat-Celtics series, which like you said, Jake, that's a series. Like, it's a good series. Featuring not one good game, which is insane to think about. And I don't know if it just because of three-point shooting, it's harder to catch up. And if one team's making, one team's missing, it's just a wrap. But like when you look at the NHL playoffs, which have been wildly competitive, remember the NFL playoffs where, what was that one weekend? Every game ended with a game-winning field goal on like divisional weekend. Like those playoffs have been astounding. The third member of the triumvirate, the NBA, just cannot buy a close game. It feels like the last exciting games were in like Suns Pelicans or that first Nets Celtics game. They desperately need something close. That's actually why I think the Warriors are going to run away with this thing. Just because in this age of the NBA, they feel... Well, also, I'm on a bit of a Warriors high as I did the DraftKings three-legged parlay last night. I called it the Splash Bros Special.
You get it?
Yep. Klay Thompson over, Steph Curry over, Warriors plus the points. Bam. Winner, winner. Chicken dinner. By the way, you too can do that on DraftKings. Three-legged same-game parlay. If one leg misses, up to $25 of your bet will be given back to you. So go ahead and take advantage of that. DraftKings, download the DraftKings Sportsbook app today. So, all right. No, maybe I'm just being biased because they won me some money.
All right, so this one hurts. I don't know. Weekend loser. Tanya Hanley. If you don't know who that is, you probably shouldn't. She placed 100 pounds, so about $125, a bet on Liverpool to win the quad, what we talked about the other day, all major trophies, right? And the Premier League would have finished the quad. And she got it at 3,671-1 odds. And she turned down a chance to cash out at $120,000. And Liverpool was right on the verge. Villa winning 2-0 in like the 75th minute. Oof. Liverpool scores. Only for Man City to score 5 goals in 3 minutes. And I've been there. Soccer is the sport that you have to go, I mean, till the final whistle. No lead is ever safe. I've been burned a lot on, like, small bets. Oof. You could have taken $120,000. Now I get it. Look, you're going for the big one. You're going for 3 times this much money. $120,000 with City, though? I don't know.
I would have empty-handed. Oh, God. I hate that. I hate that so much. It's almost so depressing that I don't want to finish the segment.
You would have cashed out, right?
Yeah.
You had the chance to win, I mean, $360,000. I get that, but 100-pound bet.
If this is deal or no deal, I'm taking the deal.
Yeah.
I'm taking the deal from the banker. Absolutely.
I mean, I'm going to think about it for like 2 seconds, but I'm taking it.
Okay, last one. Shout out to how do you pronounce Mbappe's first name? Is it Kylian? Anyway, Mbappe. How do you pronounce it? It doesn't matter. Everybody knows him as Mbappe. So am I wrong? Did he just get a signing bonus of $140 million to stay at PSG?
Oh, he got that. He has now the power to name the next coach. He's got the power to help name the next sporting director. He's got the power to bring in like which players they bring in. He's got it's his team.
He
got everything.
Actually, there's a larger conversation to be spun
and
out.
This is after tax because you know French taxes are insane. Yeah. I mean, it's like 70% taxes. Like what you just mentioned, it's like 100+ million after taxes. That was part of the contract.
Okay. Well, and we'll talk about this a bit more. We also want to talk about the New Orleans Saints. I love this piece from Rod Walker in The Advocate today. A little bit on 2019 LSU, greatest week ever. Got a lot left. Keep it left. Oh, and spread lines. Remember, with Hold the Mayo coming up next hour. Keep it locked, OTB.
Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob. ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria, and 1130 The Tiger.
Go to GEAUXroof.com, GEAUXroof.com, 927-8300, 927-8300. Go Roof! Okay? Get that free professional estimate. Doesn't cost you anything up front to figure out where the health of your roof currently stands. Once you get that free estimate, you make a fully informed decision about what you want to do next once the work begins. And look, let's say it's a big job and insurance covers it. Great. If it's a smaller job, you can put it off. Great. Till the time when maybe you're better financially that you do that. If it's something that has to be done, insurance does cover it. Well, don't worry. They will work with you to find monthly payment options that work for your situation. Because at Go Roof, all they care about is making sure that the community's roofing needs are taken care of. So call 927-8300. You're going to get a beautiful new roof every single time, and they stand by their work. Always remember, a two-year workmanship guarantee on top of that manufacturer warranty. Go to GEAUXroof.com.
In times of need, get a full list of phone numbers, websites, and other important emergency information on the Demco Stormwatch page at 1045ESPN.com.
There it is, the extra mile, on the border of expected and extraordinary for those willing to go further, like vans customized for work or play, with safety and tech to keep you connected. Supported by a five-star sales service and finance team, and backed by the one star you know. So go the extra mile. It's never crowded, because so few have what it takes to go there. Mercedes-Benz Vans.
Join 100.7 The Tiger and Our Lady of the Lake Ascension Saturday, June 25th at the Lamar Dixon Expo Center in Gonzales.
Enjoy live music from Tet Dur, Mike Broussard and the Night Train, and Jamie Badron and the Kickin' Cajuns. Make sure you grab a delicious plate of jambalaya from the Mike Ward's Liberty Safe's Jambalaya Cook-Off to raise money for the Alzheimer's services of the capital area.
The Swamp Pop Music Festival with Supreme Chevrolet.
Louisiana's Country Station.
100.7 The Tiger.
And this year, 2022, it's time to finally treat yourself. Bring your boat to the next level with front-to-back boat service. You want the latest and greatest marine technology? You want to go to the place that has not one, but two NMEA-certified techs. Family-owned and operated by the Sherman family for 30 years, front-to-back is the answer in Baton Rouge for all of your custom boat needs. So head to fronttobackboatservice.com or find them on Facebook, Front-to-Back Boat Service.
Visit Acura of Baton Rouge for attractive offers on the MDX.
If you're in an accident, a car accident, a slip and fall where you're injured, you need to call an attorney. The defendant insurance company, it's their goal to close the case as quickly as possible and pay out the least amount of money as possible. That's why it's important to call an attorney and call the law offices of O.C. Brown.
At the Law Office of O.C. Brown, we're a family-owned firm. We want to be your law firm for a lifetime.
Are you a licensed contractor? There's lots of good contractors in Louisiana doing work the right way, but unfortunately, too many unlicensed contractors are working outside the licensing requirements. Working as a contractor in Louisiana requires a license for the company doing the work. The Louisiana State Licensing Board for Contractors wants to help you get licensed to allow you to conduct work legally. It's not difficult to get the license. We can help you. Go to lacontractor.org for more information. Licensed contractors, it's the law.
Scona inviting you to join us for Monday's AFR, presented by Relief Windows. We'll recap the LSU-Vandy series, and the SEC tournament field will be set. We'll get you ready for Hoover. Join us, 3 to 6, 104.5 ESPN, Baton Rouge.
Something you said, I just died in your arms tonight.
All-Star Toyota presents Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob. ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria, and 1130 The Tiger.
Weekend loser, Mississippi State baseball.
Weekend loser or...
Well, I'm saying
2022.
Ending the season on 11 game losing streak and missing the SEC tournament, defending national champs. First time that has happened since. I guess it's the seventh time missing the NCAA tournament. It's the seventh time that it's happened since '87.
105th
extended the tournament
in the RPI.
Yeah, man. It's not the biggest deal, and all I would say is. Welcome to the club, Mississippi State fans.
It's real.
We know exactly how you feel.
Got a very 2019 feel to it.
Like, we know exactly how you feel. The interesting part for you will be, like LSU, is this a sign that things are maybe broken and have to be rebuilt? Or I would imagine it won't be that. I would imagine that they'll kind of reset, recalibrate, and be good again next year.
I would probably, if I'm betting on that, I probably would place a bet on the same side that you just laid out, T. But I will say this. A&M, better. LSU, better. Auburn, better. So some of the schools you're recruiting against and that are, you know, trying to create a buzz got better while you got worse.
Yeah.
So you do have to deal with that. Like, there's a portion of that that plays as well. They had very, very bad injuries.
Yeah.
And it continues to make the point that we're making about Jay Johnson, because their injuries happen for them in the starting rotation. It's like, okay, well, Jay Johnson's starting rotation, look at it. I mean, you have Hilliard's been a bulldog all season long, but outside of that, it's been like, man, what can we
you
patch
lost your
together?
Best
what
lefty
can we piece
like week
together?
One. You lost a starter in Beloso week one. Like, the list goes on and on, which, by the way, shout out to Rodney Beloso, the Beloso father, who he was cooking up some delicious jambalaya at Smoke 'Em If You Got 'Em yesterday, my boy Hot Rod. It was great. Smoking If You Got Them is that event. Remember that we talked about the military guys? Bro, they had the wildest silent auction I've ever seen. They had guitars signed by Hank Williams, Stapleton, Darius Rucker. They had MJ autograph, Magic Johnson autograph, Tom Brady autograph. They had a full like AR-15 out there. Like, it was wild, dude. It was all kind of jewelry. Shout out Clay Young and Don Juan. They put on a hell of an event for the military.
No, it sounds like it. You also said Hot Rod, like that movie. Very underrated.
Yes, which is what Rodney calls his catering company, Hot Rod Catering. Great name.
Is it from the movie Hot Rod?
No, his name's Rodney. I can't say I like Hot Rod. I've never seen it. I've heard great things about Hot Rod, but I see you sitting down, but I'm not the one that just tried to give
never
that movie
seen
the claim.
Hot Rod?
I know we've talked about the etymology of 3-1 great, but like Hot Rod, the movie did not make up Hot Rod. They cannot claim.
Well, I know what you're
Rod.
Saying, but still, like, you've never seen Hot Rod. It's the only place I'm.
That's on me. I got to finish Tombstone first.
And, you got so
I gotta
many movies.
Figure out what happens to our Mr. Doc Holliday. I'm sure now. I do not like this. His accent cracks you up in that movie. Okay, so when you're talking about Mbappe, that contract is fascinating for a few reasons, Jake. First off, this never goes on in American sports. La Liga is suing now PSG, right?
Yes.
And saying that this is like financially irresponsible, blah, blah, blah. But of course they are, because in the era of player empowerment, which we're seeing all over the place in the NBA,
right?
Seeing more and more in the NFL, look at Deshaun Watson, who we're going to talk about in a second. But Deshaun Watson, all the power that he commands now, like, players are realizing that the balance of power more and more is shifting into their realm. And so, yes, if I'm La Liga, or really if I'm any owner in almost any major sport around the world, I almost hope this Mbappe contract doesn't go through. Because guess what? The next guy is going to ask for it. Yeah. And the next guy is going to ask for it. And maybe it's so extreme, like it is so extreme, that maybe it doesn't become some precedent where others can follow down that road. Maybe the situation is just too unique. I mean, he's a native Parisian playing for PSG that led his country to a World Cup. Like, there's so many reasons why you go all out to keep him, right? And that's why they did. But, like, in the age where players are more and more determined, I mean, look at the Brooklyn Nets, right? Kyrie Irving talks like he is the general manager when you see him talk about the Nets. In this day and age, Mbappe is now getting that perceived power into actual contractual power. And that is pretty wild. And I wonder what the kind of, well, you're already seeing some of the bounce back and blowback as La Liga, a league, is suing PSG for this deal.
Yeah, I mean, obviously, anytime you have something like this, it's a slippery slope, and it just, how far is it going to go? How many leagues is it going to affect? How many sports is it going to affect? Will anybody else have power like this? Now, there's a handful of athletes. I mean, the number's very small. It's certainly less than 10. Might be less than 5.
Yeah.
That would have a power like this in any league, but Mbappe certainly has that power. And he was, a lot of people, I mean, there's so many edits of him out in a Madrid kit that
apparently he grew up a big Madrid. You're talking about because they thought the deal was done.
People are going to think he played for Madrid. Yeah. I mean, there's so many mock-ups of him in their kit. So they thought they had the deal done. There's probably some sour grapes there. And I mean, T, when you're talking about, I'm basically going to get to pick the coach and the sporting director and who comes in, who comes out. I mean, that's a power that nobody has ever even remotely approached.
Well, and definitely not contractually, right?
Right.
Like certainly LeBron gets to pick, you know, LeBron gets to, wherever he is at, he gets to kind of do what he wants for the most part. Kyrie and Kevin Durant, while it's not in their contract, they are being told in a lot of ways that they, well, they've kind of, Marks is now finally starting to push back on that a bit, it seems like, this offseason. But they were told, no, like, you can help run this franchise. Mbappe's the first one, though, where it's actually written into the deal.
Yeah, that's true.
Where, like, legally, if you wanted to take him to task, he'd say, no, you gave me this power.
Yeah.
This is mine now. And it's because I'm a beast. And I led my country to the World Cup.
And I
led the PSG to the Champions League Finals. And I'm, like, 25.
I'm in my early 20s.
Like, that's the difference, right? Tom Brady can do this somewhat, but at the same time, you don't overcommit to Tom Brady because he's old.
Yeah.
Mbappe's in his prime and is only going to continue to get better and better. And I mentioned Deshaun Watson because he's someone that has levels of power kind of similar to this. And let's go ahead and go to break here, and let's talk about Deshaun Watson on the other side of this thing. As Rod Walker, I think, lays it very well out in the Advocate today, as he kind of points out, look, no Deshaun, no problem. We'll get to it next here on OTB.
Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob.
Go to allstartoyotaofbatonrouge.com, allstartoyotaofbatonrouge.com. Look, man, if you are in the market for a new car, how about this? So I got brand new tires last week, right? Puncture a tire. Huge bummer. Tire pop, brand new. Still under warranty, though. Doesn't cost me anything. Free replacement. Had to go to Monroe for the weekend. What'd they do? Hook me up with a rental. Shout out Miss Lisa Session. Shout out my guy Tommy Waggis back in the service department over there. All-Star Toyota, that's the sort of family service that you get when you join the All-Star family. By the way, I got to drive a 2022 Sienna, and damn, son, the 2022 minivan is nice. It kind of makes me, like, almost wish I had never driven it, so I could, you know, because now I know what I'm missing in just the 2 years since the 2020. Look, go to allstartoyotaofbatonrouge.com.
Yeah, this is the week. Summer vacations start this week. Kids getting out of school. Go rent a Toyota from allstartoyotaofbatonrouge.com.
Our listeners fire off their opinions on the Jim's Firearms.net hotline at 499-1045. Keep listening for your next chance to shoot us your thoughts with the Jim's Firearms.net hotline on 1045 ESPN Baton Rouge.
Bayou Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram has $5,000 off the new 2022 Wagoneer. We have Wagoneers in stock with $5,000 off. All new Bayou Ford vehicles come with a 1 million mile powertrain warranty. The crew at Bayou is going to do right by you.
Gulf Coast Office Products is a nationally recognized Savin office equipment dealer based right here in Louisiana. Over 100 employees strong, Gulf Coast has the boots on the ground to support all vertical markets from education, engineering, legal, and finance. With the latest in office technology from desktop to production segment units, Gulf Coast and Savin have the perfect fit for you. Call 225-756-2644. That's 756-2644 for Gulf Coast Office Products.
Service Master Elite create clean, disinfected work environments. As a local business, we take pride in serving the New Orleans and Baton Rouge areas. Our cleaning protocols follow CDC and OSHA standards for healthcare settings, offices, senior living, restaurants, and industrial plants. Contact Service Master Elite to get your operation ready for reopening with germ disinfection cleaning. Service Master Elite, the trusted choice in professional cleaning since 1996.
This is a house call. This is a follow-up appointment. This is a diabetes checkup. This isn't just more convenient care, it's more advanced care. This is innovating healthcare at Louisiana's number one hospital, Ochsner.
I've been doing business with Luba for 25 years. They're dependable, trustworthy. It's just the attention to detail with our clients.
Our folks have years and years of experience. They're highly trained professionals, but many companies have that asset. What I'd like to think makes Luba a bit different is that we use those talents in a way that truly is dedicated to serving the needs of the folks who depend on us.
Crime has serious consequences, but anyone can make a mistake. If you find yourself in trouble with the law, know that you have rights, and it's okay to demand them. The law offices of O.C. Brown are here to protect you and your rights. Felony or misdemeanor, DUI or drug charge, no matter what crime you're accused of, you still have rights. Let the law offices of O.C. Brown uphold them. Call 225-343-1111, your law firm for a lifetime.
Gulf Coast Bank and Trust is giving our customers the power to bank anywhere, anytime during this challenging event. And we're right there with you. Our mobile banking app is a smart way to manage your money and time.
Monday evening edition of Game Time presented by Bet Rivers. We're live at Rouge Creole in Perkins Row, recapping all of the college and NFL action from the weekend on 104.5 ESPN Baton Rouge.
All-Star Toyota presents Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob. ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria, and 1130 The Tiger.
Bow, bow. Welcome back, OTB. Ooh, I don't know why it's getting me so extra fired up today, dude. I want to fire some submachine guns, do some cocaine, and make some money. Y'all in?
No.
Damn.
I'll drive the car.
Hey, great Fox.
I'll drive the car.
Hey, great foxhole guys, right, guys?
I'll drive
right?
the car.
Unbelievable.
I just, you know.
A little snow enters the foxhole and y'all get scared off. Unbelievable.
Yeah, you know, you just got to keep a clean wrap in the foxhole. I'll drive the car.
Jesus, what is this, the nerd hole?
Hey, never said it was
I'm trying to be in the Scar foxhole, okay? Are you with me in the Scar foxhole or not?
I'm in.
Say hello to my little friend.
You know, okay. Little adventure never hurt anybody.
Okay.
Danny, you
what,
in?
Danny?
T-Bob, I usually like all of your impersonations, you but like that, was so bad.
That was so bad.
That was probably the worst one you've ever
done. Do it again. Yeah, do it again. Ready?
Say hello to my little friend.
That was so bad.
What?
So bad.
You're improving, but when you first started, it was
The first one was awful. That was bad.
Okay, guys, sorry. I didn't know I was going to do a Scarface impression when I walked in. I just got
You're usually really good at it. Like, if I did it, it wouldn't matter because I don't do good impersonations.
I don't do Scarface. I don't do Scarface. It's not my repertoire.
Okay, hey. Hey.
Hey. Hey.
Don't get sensitive.
Hello, huh?
Say hello to my left friend.
Oh, look at that, dude. That was pretty good.
Better than T-Bob's?
Yeah, I would say that was better.
Yeah, way better than T-Bob.
Yeah.
Okay, screw you. I mean, there was no answer that Danny was going to give other than that. We all know this to
be true. Well, he dropped his phone for probably the 97th time in the last 3 days.
Yeah, and he keeps...
Butterfingers over there.
It's
but
the
still.
Mouse. Okay, this whole entire desk is like on a slant. I don't know why.
It really is. I don't know
that
why.
That is. I do my push-ups over there for that reason because the ground's like uneven. Yeah.
This man always has an excuse.
Oh my goodness.
And not you, Mario. Right. Don't get defensive. I was talking about Danny, okay? So you relax.
A lot of strays going on here and people are catching them.
I was talking about every time we go after Danny for something, there's always some reason why it's not his fault that whatever happened just happened.
There's too much tension lately, man. We need to go to the mountains or something. Do some bonding.
To the Indian Mountains.
The mountains?
Yes.
Indian Mountains.
Yes, we need to go bond over the Indian Mountains. As make no mistake, we will have
Mario's been watching Deliverance or something. I don't know what he's got going on.
Let's go do some mescaline at the. You know, he's talking a little team bonding. Let's go do a ropes course. I love a good teams bonding ropes course, dude. You know what else I love? The fact that as Deshaun Watson has to meet with NFL investigators, that we don't have to sit here and defend him, and talk around it, And it might be kind of viewed as a random article, but Rod Walker has a great piece in the Times-Picayune today where he's basically saying, like, and I agree, like, doesn't it feel kind of great in a lot of ways to know Deshaun Watson is not your quarterback? And look, I get it. Strictly on the football field, you would be better. But now you don't have a quarter billion of dollars committed to him, guaranteed. You don't have to worry about all the resources you gave up in the draft to get him. You don't have to worry about defending him against the mob. You don't have to worry about making peace within yourself for cheering him on with your favorite team. You don't have to worry about his meetings with NFL investigators will go. All you have to worry about is sitting back and enjoying the good-natured happiness, memeability, and likability of Jameis Winston as your quarterback. I mean, it really does feel like that analogy I used back in the day with the ring where you're kind of tempted with the one ring and you say no to it and you pass the test, even though in this case, the cup was taken from us because I was already, unfortunately, starting to be like, well, you know, the Saints have investigators and if they're cool, then I guess we have to be cool with it. I'm just glad that now we don't have to do that dance at all. Jameis over everything.
Yeah.
Number two over number four.
We talked a lot about it. I mean, we spent a lot of time, obviously, because it kind of came out of nowhere as well. So obviously we had a reaction and then you go back and you look at it and you try to figure out what's the best for the organization. And you kind of knew like that, like these were things that were coming. They were not going to just go away. So obviously it's a situation that's still going on. Like you really, I guess, don't know the final outcome of it, but you were able to use that salary cap. And like, if you're just talking about an on the field portion of this and not all the off the field stuff that you laid out, because that's the obvious, like that's something that's still in the air. The on-the-field portion, like you spent the money that you cleared up to potentially add him on a lot of really good football players.
Yeah, that's another great point. Like, if Deshaun Watson comes, you don't have Tyrann Mathieu.
Yeah, no Jarvis.
You don't have Jarvis Landry. Well, maybe.
Maybe Jarvis, but does Jarvis come if, you know, Tyron's not
that's
here?
That's a great point. Yes, I don't know.
What does the draft go the same way? Like, I don't know. Like, it's all like butterfly effect kind of stuff. Like, we don't know.
And
but,
it's tough to say. I mean, who knows?
You know, May at safety? Do you have the money to sign him? Do you have to go cheaper? I don't know.
Yeah, you definitely don't go May at safety, I don't think. You know? I doubt you could afford that. And then, like, you don't know how his peers feel about Deshaun Watson at this point. Like, even if you personally like him, you know if you are on his team, you are walking into a media circus. Like, is anybody happier than Dennis Allen right now? And you could say, well, he would have won more. Maybe he wins more. I don't know.
You know what?
He doesn't have to answer questions every single day now about why he took this chance on this case.
I mean.
Sounds awful.
You also got purgatory here. I completely forgot Baker Mayfield's still a Brown.
I know.
He's just out there in purgatory right now.
Well, it's because the Browns, the Steelers, and I don't know if they're messing with the Browns, but they've already said it. Like, the second they would cut Baker Mayfield, the Steelers would sign him.
Oh, without question, I think they would.
the Browns are desperately trying to get someone to take a deal for Baker, and basically everybody's saying, why? Like,
they know the leverage is gone. There's
yes,
no draft.
Yes, exactly.
And, okay, so if you want to look at, does Baker Mayfield have flaws as a quarterback? Yeah, he does. 2018, those for 27 touchdowns, 14 interceptions. You move to 2019, 22 and 21, okay? That's not a great year by any means. The next year, 26 touchdowns, only 8 interceptions. All right, so he improves. Last year, 17 and 13. He's not a perfect quarterback by any means. He is a starting caliber quarterback, though, I think we can agree,
yes,
in the NFL.
Played hurt last year, man, and people are burning him for it.
Number one overall pick. He's led his team to the playoffs before. He'd be in the back half of starting quarterbacks. I'm not saying otherwise. But there's teams that would definitely take him, but they know the Browns have no leverage.
Yeah.
They know that the Browns are probably going to have to release him. So they're waiting on that. They don't want to give up an asset, even if it's a bad asset. Like, no, we're not. You have to. You're not keeping Mayfield and Deshaun Watson. It's just not happening.
No, I don't think Mayfield's going
to
give
you. And you sign other veteran quarterbacks the Browns have, like, to be the backup as well. So, like, they know that he's got to get released at some point. And I understand the Browns being like, wow, man, oof, we really don't want to have to play him in the division there. But you might have to, because not only did you bring in Deshaun Watson, Jacoby Brissett, and Joshua Dobbs. Like, you have all those quarterbacks there. So,
closing out hour two with a quick segment next, and then another full, long hour as we'll have our guy Spread Lines coming up with Hold the Mayo. Still going to get to this 2019 LSU piece. Keep it locked here on OTB.
Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob.
Go to ITI Technical College, iticollege.edu, iticollege.edu. So the new semester is about to begin. if you want to go ahead and get involved. Remember, this is a local family-owned campus here. Okay, family-owned school. I should say local here in Baton Rouge. The campus is here in Baton Rouge. They got a great lake on campus, great classrooms. They got replica facilities of, you know, the facilities you'll be working on in these trade jobs. And so in 1 to 2 years, you can get that AOS degree and change your life for the better with the locals at ITI Technical College.
Local number, 225-267-8003 is the number. Once you call that number, say, hey, I heard on Off the Bench, I could call and you could help me get a plan in place. And they'll say, absolutely, we're going to get you to the finish line. And that's exactly what they're going to do. So if you've been wanting to do it, you've been wanting to take that leap, 225-267-8003.
In times of need, get a full list of phone numbers, websites, and other important emergency information on the Demco Stormwatch page at 1045ESPN.com.
Bayou Ford has the new inventory to get you in a new Ford truck or SUV today, or customize your next vehicle just the way you want. All new Bayou Ford vehicles come with a 1 million mile powertrain warranty. The crew at Bayou Ford is going to do right by you.
Gulf Coast Bank and Trust is giving our customers the power to bank anywhere, anytime during this challenging event. And we're right there with you. Our mobile banking app is a smart way to manage your money and time. Gulf Coast Bank and Trust, the bank that cares about you.
It's no secret. The best oysters in Baton Rouge are at Jolie Pearl Oyster Bar. Enjoy mouth-watering South Louisiana flavor and oysters from all over the country. And don't forget our nightly drink specials. Jolie Pearl Oyster Bar, located in downtown Baton Rouge.
Eli's always been into grilling. It took us a while to see it, but the signs were there.
What are you doing, Eli?
I knew grilling was my thing. I have been talking about it throughout my career.
Happy with the results?
I am. Got the new grill from barbecueguys.com. It performed great.
My advice, as I always told my boys,
do more of what you're born to do.
Barbecue Guys, for those who are born to grill.
You want cheese on your burger, Pops?
I'll take a little cheese.
In this year, 2022, it's time to finally treat yourself. Bring your boat to the next level with front-to-back boat service. You want the latest and greatest marine technology? You want to go to the place that has not one, but two NMEA-certified techs. Family-owned and operated by the Sherman family for 30 years, front-to-back is the answer in Baton Rouge for all of your custom boat needs. So head to fronttobackboatservice.com or find them on Facebook, Front to Back Boat Service.
Visit Acura of Baton Rouge for attractive offers on the MDX.
If you're in an accident, a car accident, a slip and fall where you're injured, you need to call an attorney. The defendant insurance company, it's their goal to close the case as quickly as possible and pay out the least amount of money as possible. That's why it's important to call an attorney and call the law offices of O.C. Brown.
At the Law Office of O.C. Brown, we're a family-owned firm. We want to be your law firm for a life.
Monday edition of Hunt and Hill. Get the recap from LSU and Vanderbilt. Where's LSU's NCAA tournament resume? And we'll get you ready for Hoover. Hunt and Hill, noon to two weekdays on 104.5 ESPN, Baton Rouge.
All-Star Toyota presents Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob. ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria, and 1130 The Tiger.
Hi.
I'm talking a lot of trash right now, but yes, I think I'm just projecting for my own insecurities, my own upsetness at myself, because we've been so long during weekend winters. It's only going to be a minute right here. But then we're going to reset, kick off hour number three. You got 2019 LSU. We still got, again, spread lines. Got you the greatest week ever. Best gender reveal, a ton coming up. Hold the Mayo coming up at 9:15. So keep it locked. Hit the like button. We're only at 60 likes. I got a lot more people than that watching. So hit the like button. A again, if you want to be mad at anybody for this short segment, be mad at me. This is my fault. And I will make it up to you with a lot of funny jokes and good impressions. Yeah, you should point at yourself.
I did.
Mean, yeah, good. Okay.
Right. We both learned into Les Miles. Can't help it.
Yeah,
off
exactly.
The bench with Hester and T-Bob.
Only a second left. Spike it! Spike it! Spike it now! Oh, that's not good clock management. Oh, that's
hey,
my bad.
Oh, even LSU Auburn 07, like, coach, we got to snap it.
No, you don't.
We got to snap it.
No, you don't. Just bomb it to the end zone, yes. Baby. Don't think too. You're thinking
thank
too
you.
Much.
Thank you, Will Muschamp, for that defense.
Thinking too much. It's like when you got to think about urgent care, don't think too much. Just go to Patient Plus.
Yeah.
And once you see the facilities, you'll be like, oh, I get it now, T-Bob. But they got 8 locations in Baton Rouge right now. They got more right around the corner. Got 9 locations overall. Again, I want to hammer the occupational medicine front because I think it's an area that's underserved here. You're probably going, like, I remember taking a drug test, going to, like, some dingy, weird office. Very uncomfortable feeling. Not the case when you work with Patient Plus, okay? You go to their mid-city location. It's top-notch. And if you are a business and you need all of your occupational medicine needs met, you want to go to Patient Plus Urgent Care.
PatientPlusUC.com. Get in. Get better. PatientPlusUC.com.
I've been doing business with Luba for 25 years. They're dependable, trustworthy. It's just the attention to detail with our clients.
Our folks have years and years of experience. They're highly trained professionals, but many companies have that asset. What I'd like to think makes Luba a bit different is that we use those talents in a way that truly is dedicated to serving the needs of the folks who depend on us.
To Corvell Toyota to pre-order your next vehicle, and you'll never pay over MSRP. Browse, reserve, pick up, and enjoy. It's that simple. So come on down to Happy Town. That's Corvell Toyota in Opelousas, Happy Town, USA.
Are you a licensed contractor? There's lots of good contractors in Louisiana doing work the right way, but unfortunately, too many unlicensed contractors are working outside the licensing requirements. Working as a contractor in Louisiana requires a license for the company doing the work. The Louisiana State Licensing Board for Contractors wants to help you get licensed to allow you to conduct work legally. It's not difficult to get the license. We can help you. Go to lacontractor.org for more information. Licensed contractors, it's the law.
Gulf Coast Office Products is a nationally recognized Savin office equipment dealer based right here in Louisiana. Over 100 employees strong, Gulf Coast has the boots on the ground to support all vertical markets from education, engineering, legal, and finance. With the latest in office technology from desktop to production segment units, Gulf Coast and Savin have the perfect fit for you. Call 225-756-2644. That's 756-2644 for Gulf Coast Office Products.
Service Mastery Elite create clean, disinfected work environments. As a local business, we take pride in serving the New Orleans and Baton Rouge areas. Our cleaning protocols follow CDC and OSHA standards for healthcare settings, offices, senior living, restaurants, and industrial plants. Contact Service Mastery Elite to get your operation ready for reopening with germ disinfection cleaning. Service Mastery Elite, the trusted choice in professional cleaning since 1996.
This is a house call. This is a follow-up appointment. This is a diabetes checkup. This isn't just more convenient care, it's more advanced care. This is innovating healthcare at Louisiana's number one hospital, Ochsner.
Good morning. It's 9 a.m. on Monday, May 23rd. Today in Baton Rouge, expect to see cloudy skies with a high of 84. If you missed hours one or two of the show, you can now catch that up at the on-demand section at 1045ESPN.com. Coming up on OTBOT, Hold the Mayo joins the show at 9:15 for spread lines. You can follow us on Twitter, Instagram, and TikTok at OTB_ESPN, or you can watch us on YouTube at the 1045 ESPN channel and subscribe for daily content. OTBOT, live from the Mercedes-Benz of Baton Rouge studio, starts now.
All-Star Toyota presents Off the Bench with Jacob Hester and T-Bob Hebert. Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob.
Hey, they said I got to come off the bench.
All-Star Toyota presents Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob. Yo, yo, yo.
It's just like when y'all tried to go Hans Zimmer versus John Williams, and I had to slap you down with a resume. Hans Zimmer can still get there, but he's not there yet.
Just like we had to slap you down with Taco Bell and Burger King. I get it. Like, we all have wins.
I mean, you know,
off the top of my head,
you know,
I said
again, though, I
Christian
right.
Bale might be the actor of our generation.
Again, though, I want to reinforce, I just am right it. About Taco Bell. The rest of the world is wrong, is what I'm
okay.
saying.
Oh, okay.
No, yeah, okay. I like Christian Bale. We can't get caught up in the moment and give him best actor of the generation when Leonardo DiCaprio is in that same generation. And we could say that
Leo's great.
I will give that Tom Cruise is an older generation. Like, I'll put him a step ahead of Bale, and that's all well and good, even though you could argue the same generation. But both Tom and Leo would be over Bale. I mean, Bale's great. It's okay. He's still in the top five. It's like I was watching randomly for some reason the other night. I was watching Usain Bolt's record 200-meter run, the world record. He went 19:19, right? And I'm thinking about the guy who got second, who ran like an incredible time.
Yeah.
Right? And it doesn't matter. Nobody gives a damn. Nobody remembers him. You're the second fastest person in the world. I can't remember what his final time is. Maybe the second even fastest person of all time. And it doesn't matter because you weren't number one. Okay. Thankfully, acting's not as much like that. So there's no problem in Christian Bale being a top five of his generation or anything like that. He's just not number one. This is what it is.
To you.
T-Bob, you're such a hater.
Why? Why?
You hate on everything me and Hester.
Everything.
So you would take Christian Bale's career over Leonardo DiCaprio's?
He just it's not even saying like taking career. You're talking about like just like the acting and the range and the things he's done. Like
yes,
Leo and Christian are the conversation. They're the conversation. Just saying.
I mean, I can come up with a third actor that I think probably beats Bale. I'll have to think about it for a minute. But Leo smashes. Like, it's not even close. Bale can be he can be first of the rest. He can be the best of the rest if you want to do that. But like, Danny, you can't even say it with a straight face. Tell me that Christian Bale's had is better than Leo,
but thank I you. Think exactly. he's better than Tom Cruise.
I don't know. I'm not there yet.
I mean,
Ford versus Ferrari, him as Ken Miles, man, that was really, really good. That's just like one that doesn't even. Okay, here's
the head body. Fighter Christian Bale. Great Christian Bale. Love him.
I thought you were making fun of that movie. Like,
no,
what?
Great movie.
Look, Thor, Love and Thunder is going to be a real test for Bale. How, if he can pull off a superhero movie with all the other parts of his resume, because could Leo pull off like the villain in a superhero movie?
Leo would smash a Marvel movie. If you tell me you wouldn't be excited if you knew Leo was going to be in a Marvel movie. Who's Bale playing in Thor? He's playing Zeus? I can't wait.
No,
he's playing Gore the God Butcher. Yeah.
Okay. I don't know about who Gore the God Butcher is, but damn, that sounds tight. that's a badass name on the list of names. Being named Gore the God Butcher is wild. Like, it just feels powerful off the bat. So look, it's all well and good, boys. Bale can still be great.
I love how you speak in absolutes.
Yeah, like a Sith. Look, I can't help it that I am right on everything.
I know.
And sometimes
I know.
People are also right.
You
and sometimes
used to not
wrong.
Be like that. What happened?
No. Then you did not know me enough. Ask Rivers.
Started hanging out. What's going on?
Why do you think me?
I think
Rivers,
that's. I mean,
I know that. I know.
We've
I
done this show for over a year, almost like a year and a half now. No, it has been a year and a half.
I get the bit that you're all trying to do. But
I know.
Why did me and Rivers almost come to blows?
I wasn't here. I don't know.
Multiple times this studio.
I've never been here when Rivers was the producer.
Yeah, because it's tough because I'm right all the time, and sometimes I just can't make people realize I'm right, and it's like so hard.
So I need to call Rivers, Jordy, and Nathan, and get their opinion on this too.
What in turn? He will absolutely tell you that, yes, I think I'm always right.
I'm going to ask.
Unfortunately, it's something that I try to work on. But in this Leo thing, I am right. I mean, let's be honest here. Speaking of being right, I don't have a...
Doesn't love that one.
Yeah, I don't have a good transition.
Doesn't love that one.
I don't like this at all. In fact, I actually don't even know if I like this topic as much. Do you all care about this? Jeff Duncan has a piece about 2019 LSU where he like just lays out.
Do y'all care about this?
I mean, I don't, it felt good this morning putting it together. Now I'm a little unsure about how interesting
it
is.
Well, I probably threw you off with the Christian Bale comment right before you came back on. You weren't ready for that.
Well, like now I'm more into talking about that though and talking about what this week is going to be in terms of pop culture, I think, than I am about.
This is a great pop culture week. There's a lot of things that we not only like, but we love that are happening this week. I mean, you've probably been waiting for an Obi-Wan, you know, series, a standalone, like whatever, for a long time. You're also getting Hayden Christensen back.
Yeah.
Like, I've got a soft spot for him. I watched Jumper over the weekend.
Oh, really? What led you to Jumper? Our talk of it last week?
I didn't even mean to. I just stumbled upon Jumper. It was on my DirecTV, and I was like, we talked about this. Let me watch this. And I picked up about 15 minutes in, watched that. So big for that. Huge for Top Gun. We've been waiting over 35 years for a Top Gun sequel. And normally you don't ever get it. If you've been waiting that long, like if you get the sequel, the second one, it's just you've built it up to be something. It's been too long. The moment has moved on. And you know what I'm talking about. Like we've had movies.
Also a troubled production. Right, it's gotten pushed back.
I mean, pushback. It was supposed to come out in 2019.
Yes.
Yeah. Speaking of 2019, I mean, look, Boondock Saints for me. I'm going to go see it, and I did. I drove up from San Diego to Irvine just to see it. Boondock Saints was not as good as one, and we waited a long time for it. Okay, this is like 1,000 times bigger, and not only did you have to wait 35 plus years for the sequel, but it's still like relevant. It feels like in the reviews. Reviews are what make the excitement that much better. Because I'm going to go see this. T-Bob, if it would have got a 5.4 on IMDb,
yeah, we were, see it
we
anyway,
were all going to go see it. Like we already agreed to it. But the fact that it's getting the reviews that it's getting, like that makes it even better. So, yeah, pop culture, big, big win for pop culture this week.
Yeah, and like Danny said, I mean, I'm very excited for Stranger Things. So this is going to be part one of season four, right? And then we get part two later this summer. Still unsure why they didn't push back to an October release there, but whatever, it doesn't matter. Because I have such
I think
fun.
Like COVID like ruined all their scheduling plans.
And I'm sure that the financials go way beyond me, and it has something to do with like fiscal quarters and trying to get earnings in. But like I do feel that, I mean, I have such positive memories of Stranger Things season one dropping around Halloween and being like, whoa, what is this like horror 80s TV show at Halloween? Like the vibes were immaculate. There would have been a nice rhythm to finishing the show in October. It doesn't matter though.
Yeah, I love the October release.
Yeah, they're great. They're the best. Yeah. It's like why did the new Scream come out in January or February? That is a monumental F up there. But again, I'm sure it has to do with fiscal earnings and needing to get that movie out and make money and everything else. But yes, so look, I thought that Stranger Things season two was a bit too dour, a bit too dark, kind of lost its way, a bit too serious. I thought season three recaptured some of that season one magic, and I'm fascinated to see if they can land this plane. The hardest thing to do when you make something like this is to keep it going and then come up with a satisfying ending, right? Think about your favorite TV shows ever. Which ones have really had satisfying endings? I mean, even True Detective season one, which I absolutely adore as maybe the greatest piece of television ever made, the ending was a bit all right, right? It wasn't bad. But it wasn't great. The Harry Potter.
Same thing in season three. Season three, True Detective, fantastic. But the ending,
And while season three never, it was fantastic. I don't think it reached the heights of one, was great.
Much better than two.
And then at the end, it was just like, hey, let's just have like 20 minutes of exposition, and that's going to be the final episode. And it's kind of like, Now, still very talented, very good show or whatever, but it's like, okay, the Harry Potter book series, not a highly satisfying ending.
Game of Thrones,
awful ending. Star Wars, the Skywalker saga. Rise of Skywalker is now deadpanned as maybe the worst Star Wars movie that's ever been made. It's like down there with like Attack of the Clones, which I kind of been watching a little bit recently. Love it again. But yeah, it's tough, man. What is the best ending in terms of a show that was majorly popular ever. Nobody likes a Seinfeld ending, right?
No, all in jail.
That always gets made fun of.
I mean, I like Sopranos. I don't know how y'all feel about the ending of Sopranos. Like,
that's the infamous now spoiler.
Yeah,
spoiler.
But you still don't know.
I like leaving it open.
So I don't even feel like. And to be fair, I haven't watched Sopranos, so I don't know. But I've read about this where it just cuts to black, right?
Yeah.
At the end? Tony's cooking.
He cuts
the black.
No, he's in a restaurant.
They're in a restaurant.
Okay, they're in a restaurant.
Him and the family, yeah.
So there is an earlier Sopranos episode where I think Tony alludes, because the writers come out and talked about it, where a couple seasons before he's talking about just that, how that's how it happens. You're kind of sitting there living your everyday life, and then all of a sudden everything goes black because you just got hit.
Yep.
And mafia men get hit at restaurants all the time, right? So, like, I don't even think that open-ended. Like, he dies.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah, he dies right there. And that's a good ending. I agree.
But it
that's
doesn't
pretty
show
satisfying.
It.
Yeah, they don't show it. So, still, like, that little percentage. Yeah.
which I think, to Danny's point, that's a good narrative decision. I agree with you there. Okay, so Sopranos maybe early on that list for a show that landed the plane in the right time. I wonder what the other ones would be.
That's actually a great question, because there's a lot of really good series.
Breaking Bad. People a lot of
I was gonna say Breaking Bad.
Jackson, you can still not watch that. No,
sorry.
Dude. Yeah, not happening, brother. Just ain't gonna work.
Hashtag Ask the Bench. Your thoughts on shows with a laugh track? There's a place for them.
There
man.
Was a place in the '90s, certainly the '80s, maybe.
I think there's still a place for just a good turn your brain off, like
probably
Everybody Loves Raymond sort of sitcom, like Two and a Half Men, where you're just like
favorite sitcom like that growing. Like, what's your favorite sitcom like that? Mine's Martin. I can watch Martin right now. I'm gonna laugh just the same as I did in the '90s.
As much as I was saying there's a place for it, I don't know that I watched many past full, Full House. I never really got into Two and a Half Men beyond when I'd be in the training room and I'd be like, oh, it's kind of funny.
Ooh, The Wire was good.
Fresh Prince, I grew up on, was a show like that.
Yeah, Fresh Prince is a great laugh track. Sure, I could go with probably Fresh Prince or Saved by the Bell or Full House is the ones that I watched the most in that regard. Always Sunny does not have a laugh track. Always Sunny's also not done yet.
Curb as well, like dry humor, off the cuff.
Yeah, Curb's still going on, right?
Yeah,
in their new season right around the corner.
Veep's great.
What?
Veep.
I've heard Veep is very good. I've never seen Veep. All right, when we get back here, let's get into a little spread lines with our guy Devin Snow, aka Hold the Mayo. We got let's see what we got. We got a little John Daly, we got a little Renona Wider, Tom from MySpace, Baskin Robbins, Albert Pujols, and the mighty Morphin Prison Ranger. Keep it locked here on OTB.
OTB OT.
Go to airflownow.com. Airflownow.com and get the Tiger Air insert for your hard hat today. That's right, folks. If you're listening at home and you run a construction company, or maybe you happen to work at a plant or run a plant, your employees deserve the best, which means they deserve this Tiger Air insert from airflownow.com. Look, you just put this thing in your helmet, okay? Put this thing in your hard hat, turn it on. For 8 hours, your body basically becomes a walking AC unit. Fight that Louisiana heat.
You better start yelling.
Safe. Go to airflownow.com.
I mean, look, we have it right here. And how many weeks have we been doing this? They still got battery. We've been doing this for multiple weeks. It still got battery. Same charge, right? It's going to last you 3.5 ounces, 8 hours of runtime, waterproof, hard hat here, insert here. You clip it in, and your body becomes an AC. So it's a no-brainer. Everything that you need for the South Louisiana heat, you've got here. Airflownow.com, airflownow.com.
Our listeners fire off their opinions on the JimsFirearms.net hotline at 499-1045. Keep listening for your next chance to shoot us your thoughts with the JimsFirearms.net hotline on 1045 ESPN Baton Rouge.
Bayou Ford has the new inventory to get you in a new Ford truck or SUV today, or customize your next vehicle just the way you want. All new Bayou Ford vehicles come with a 1 million mile powertrain warranty. The crew at Bayou Ford is going to do right by you.
Join 100.7 The Tiger and Our Lady of the Lake Ascension Saturday, June 25th at the Lamar Dixon Expo Center in Gonzales.
Enjoy live music from Tet Dur, Mike Broussard and the Night Train, and Jamie Badron and the Kickin' Cajuns. Make sure you grab a delicious plate of jambalaya from the Mike Ward's Liberty Safe's Jambalaya Cook-Off to raise money for the Alzheimer's services of the capital area.
The Swamp Pop Music Festival with Supreme Chevrolet.
Louisiana's country station.
100.7 The Tiger.
I've been doing business with Luba for 25 years. They're dependable, trustworthy. It's just the attention to detail with our clients.
Our folks have years and years of experience. They're highly trained professionals. But many companies have that asset. What I'd like to think makes Luba a bit different is that we use those talents in a way that truly is dedicated to serving the needs of the folks who depend on us.
Crime has serious consequences, but anyone can make a mistake. If you find yourself in trouble with the law, know that you have rights, and it's okay to demand them. The law offices of O.C. Brown are here to protect you and your rights. Felony or misdemeanor, DUI or drug charge, no matter what crime you're accused of, you still have rights. Let the law offices of O.C. Brown uphold them. Call 225-343-1111, your law firm for a lifetime.
It's no secret. The best oysters in Baton Rouge are at Jolie Pearl Oyster Bar. Enjoy mouth-watering South Louisiana flavor and oysters from all over the country. And don't forget our nightly drink specials. Jolie Pearl Oyster Bar, located in downtown Baton Rouge.
Eli's always been into grilling. It took us a while to see it, but the signs were there.
What are you doing, Eli?
I knew grilling was my thing. I have been talking about it throughout my career.
Happy with the results?
I am. Got the new grill from barbecueguys.com. It performed great.
My advice, as I always told my boys,
do more of what you're born to do.
Barbecue Guys, for those who were born to grill.
You want cheese on your burger, Pops?
I'll take a little cheese.
Le posso offrire un caffè?
Le posso offrire un caffè?
Andiamo insieme da me, non c'è.
Oh, oh, oh.
Call Mr.
For a Monday edition of Early Line, as we recap the sports weekend, including both conference finals in the NBA and the rest of LSU baseball series against Vanderbilt. Join us from 2 to 3 p.m., 104.5 ESPN Baton Rouge.
OTB OT with Hester and T-Bob on 104.5 ESPN Baton Rouge and 94.7 ESPN Alexandria.
Welcome back. OTB OT. Hour number three, hit the like button. If you're watching online, please, the algorithmic gods that fuel us. And yes, when you start to make it, the haters come out the woodwork. Why? Because they're jealous. And there's a lot of jealousy going on with our boy Devin Snow, a.k.a. Hold the Mayo, a.k.a. the forefather of the greatest tradition in the world, the greatest city in the world. It is RB&R Day. It is Monday. It is time for some spread lines brought to you by TASS. Dev, what's happening, bro?
What's up? How we feeling?
Feeling great, man. Feel great today. Like I said, man, for all of us Star Wars nerds out here and really just pop culture nerds, it is just an unbelievable week with Obi-Wan and Stranger Things and Top Gun 2. Like, if you want to catch me this weekend, you will find me glued to a television. Bottom line. Dev, where do you stand in terms of your pop culture interests? I know you love video games, but, like, do you roll with Star Wars or Lord of the Rings or anything like that? Harry Potter?
Yeah, I mean, I guess in this order it would be, like, I love Star Wars.
Okay.
But I don't necessarily agree that the first three of those series in the early 2000s, I don't agree that those were bad movies.
Yeah,
so, yeah. So I really enjoyed those.
Hell yeah.
The newer ones are kind of, I don't know, I'm just traditional. So the newer ones are kind of harder for me to love.
Yeah.
But I've watched them all.
My next
pop culture thing would be video games. You know, I love playing video games and stuff like that. Lord of the Rings, it's been a while, dude. But I'm cool with it.
Yeah, just wait. I can't wait. Whenever I have so there is a urologist here in Baton Rouge whose name is quite literally a penile pun, And when I decide to, cut my balls so I can never have kids again, I'm already planning the weekend out. I'm going to watch all three Lord of the Rings Extended Edition again, and I cannot wait. Also, I want to make it into an advertising bit so I can get it for free, because there is nothing more representative of the local radio man than doing ads to get a vasectomy for free. It's, I mean, life is good. We'll see if life is good, if I can pull it off.
Really, really enjoyed that, T-Bob. Because, I mean, dude, look. I mean, getting snipped is in, man. You know?
Why not, dude? Why
not? And your roots are from Cutoff, even though you may have not. I don't know if you lived in Cutoff growing up.
No, I
didn't. But getting snipped in Cutoff is a huge thing, bro. So that's awesome how you're continuing that tradition.
I did like, what did you call Limoncello LaCroix yesterday?
It's like the North Shore's, Sunday baby shower beverage.
Yes, that is maybe the best description I've ever heard of Limoncello LaCroix. All right, what do we got on these spread lines for this weekend, Dev?
What's up, Jacob? How you doing, bro?
What's up, Dev? How you doing, man? I mean, T-Bob just always, he just gets the mic, Dev, and he's just like,
wow.
Like, I'm going to ask the questions, and I'm going to ask the second question, then I'm going to ask a third question, then I'm going to get the spread line. Dev, I appreciate you asking how I'm doing, and I'm glad you're doing well.
I'm just a
I mean, just didn't hear from you for a minute, and I mean, then I thought about it, like, T-Bob was talking about getting snipped for
I know.
God knows.
Well, I mean, and you know me, like, I've got, like, 37 kids, so that's, like, not something I'm all about, so.
I don't want to ever, I don't want to ever have the ability to get one past the goalie ever again. I want to hang up my skates, turn in my stick, and ride away into the sunset there. All right, Dev, what do we got on the docket this weekend?
Let's keep it top culture.
Wait, hello, Dev?
Yeah.
Okay, we got you back. Shout out who?
Yeah. Shout out Winona Ryder.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's a great week to shout out Winona Ryder. I don't think that she really gets enough talk. Obviously, Stranger Things, which I haven't even seen, but I can just tell she probably does a good performance. I'm going to be honest. I haven't seen Stranger Things.
Wow, okay.
Yeah, and then Mr. Deeds stands out for me with Winona. Beetlejuice.
Great. Edward Scissorhands.
Beetlejuice 2 in the works, by the way, as well.
Dude, I just found out Gladiator 2 is in the works. What are we doing?
I don't know about that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know about that one either.
That's rough. But, yeah, just wanted to put, shout out to her. I mean, she smokes Joe's.
Burns some heaters.
Yeah, burns heaters. She's been caught shoplifting, which isn't really cool, but it's also, like, it's not really not cool, you know?
That's a pretty great description of shoplifting, how a lot of kids have approached shoplifting throughout their life. Look, Winona's a great girl. But what triggered this Winona love here, Dev? Was it an interview? Why do you have
just the Stranger Things coming? Stranger Things coming back, and then I don't know, man. I just kind of thought about her. It's kind of how I think about Renee Zellweger too. Like, I've just really underrated careers.
Is it the same way that you were texting me about matches the other day?
Yeah.
Where it is 7 p.m. at night. Me and Dev are not talking about anything. And he texts me, matches are such a simple thing.
Yeah.
But, like, what was the benefit for folks who created matches? Did they just make them to help us all during times of crisis with no flame available for free? Such a simple item, but so many layers to the match. They came out of nowhere on a Wednesday night last week.
Yeah, who's buying matches? They're always there. They're so much more durable than the average Bic lighter.
Yeah.
And again, like, who created them? What was the benefit of this person creating matches? Obviously, he wasn't looking for financial gain.
Dev, if you're pulling a heater, which you've been known to do, what kind of lighter do you use? I can envision you having something like nostalgic, maybe like an old school lighter.
Yeah, I don't really have like any lighter, like, you know, really anything. Circle K lighter right now is what I'm looking at.
Hell yeah. Man of the people.
I can see him pulling out like one of the long ones you like light a fire with. It just happened to get in the house, Dev. If you ever pulled out one of those, your back pocket.
Oh yeah, that, the stove, everything. I mean, you got to do what you got to do, man. One thing I'm not gonna do is go run to the store to go buy a whole new lighter. Like, you know, I'll rub two sticks together and try to make a flame before I do that.
Yeah, I will say this: the invention of matches. If you're talking about the democratization of fire, right? Like, it has to be one of the greatest inventions in human history. And I wonder how these come. I mean, obviously, like, restaurants are buying them in bulk, but, Yeah, I don't know when the last time I bought any matches were. All right, other spread lines to get to here. This is a new segment, I'm guessing, here. Dev, who was your Task Performer of the Week?
Yeah, shout out Task. Just awesome gear over at Task. But, I mean, also performance-wise, I mean, this past weekend, John Daly.
Yeah.
John Daly, who yes, he finished plus eight. Nothing, you know, spectacular. But this man started out hot. He finished 18 holes. He smoked 21 cigarettes, drank 12 Diet Cokes, and ate 6 packs of peanut M&Ms.
Yep. And had zero waters in that entire mix, right? Not an ounce of water anywhere in there.
Been playing golf for 20-plus years. Just a true competitor, man. And it shows you, man, like, live your life, bro. You know, I'm sure he's had a wild life, you know, but at least he's happy now. Playing golf, smoking Joes, drinking Diet Cokes, which I never really understood the Diet Coke hype. I don't know how a man could drink 12 Diet Cokes. Like, out of everything he did, the Diet Cokes is the problem for me.
Now that I'm older, though, I'm kind of getting it, man, right? You want a little bit of flavor, but you don't want the calories. And, yeah, it doesn't taste as good, but you sacrifice it. And then if you go down that road and up, then you start to get addicted to it, and then you just start rolling with it. Like, I can actually see it. And he can't drink beer during an actual PGA tournament.
Yeah, I guess I don't understand what tastes good about Diet Coke. Is it the initial taste?
So I feel like I drink a lot of, like, I drink a lot of stuff that I don't know that I would have thought, like, tastes good, but it tastes, right? So it's like,
yeah,
like, if you go over to the only water thing, which obviously for years and years I stopped drinking, like, soda and other stuff like that. But, like, sometimes you just want something that tastes. And then I think, like, coffee or anything else, you can quickly start to crave that taste, even if it's something you didn't originally love.
Yeah, I think that's just what it is. Gotta be.
How about 21 Joes and 18 holes of golf?
Pretty impressive.
Like, the M&Ms is like something, like, I can get behind that. Like, I could probably smoke six bags of peanut M&Ms pretty quick.
That's way too many peanut M&Ms. No. I think that's way too many. Well, that's awful.
Yeah, and then the 21 cigs, it's like a pack is 20, so the extra one was really just a statement. It was just a principle.
It was the one behind his ear.
Yeah, it's like a loose one.
Okay, so also on spread lines this week, again, John Daly, your Task Performer of the Week for putting up such an incredible performance. What's going on with Tom from MySpace?
Nothing at all other than just he's off the map. Nobody's heard from him, but I do want to say shout out Tom from MySpace because, you know, Elon Musk or whatever is supposedly, you know, going to get Twitter, not going to get Twitter. But I just want to remember Tom because everything was good on MySpace when Tom was around. Then he sold the thing for bazillions of dollars, and you never heard from him again. He was your first friend. He was always online. Tom was always there. Yeah. Just Tom in a white Hanes shirt by a dry erase board. Shout out Tom.
He sold it to News Corp in 2005 for $580 million.
Yeah, and you remember how much Timberlake ended up buying it for?
And then 6 years later, MySpace sold again for $35 million.
Yeah, I think that was to Timberlake, a group that Timberlake had. Because they had, like, a little bit of a music angle I think they were trying to make happen.
Oh, that, I didn't know that. I didn't know that the actual – that Timberlake, the dude that played – what's his name? In Social Network.
Oh, yeah, I guess it's true. I didn't think about it from that angle.
Well, they bought it for – actually, they made a pretty good investment because they bought it for $35 million in 11, and then in 16, they sold it for $87 million to Time, Inc.
Okay, dude. Okay.
Good, so that's a pretty good investment there.
The only thing I hated about MySpace was the autoplaying music. If you run a website and you have autoplaying videos or any autoplaying sound, it just makes me ridiculously angry. Also, the top friends circle was a great way to start drama back in the day.
I loved that. That was the best part.
I was into that.
Oh, wow.
That was cool.
I didn't like it, dude. It just.
Well, you hate confrontation, though.
Yeah, that's fair. That's fair. It just heated things up a little too much for my taste.
And MySpace profile songs, like, that was when Lil Wayne was so popular. And, like, dude, everybody in Louisiana had Lil Wayne MySpace profile songs. It was just awesome.
Okay, next on the list, we got shout out Baskin Robbins. What's going on with the many, many flavors of Baskin Robbins?
Well, I don't want to stay too long on this, but I do want to shout out Baskin Robbins because, for me, another nostalgic establishment that just never really let me down, but also a place that's not going to get a lot of love today. You know, it's just, to me, their milkshakes are top-notch. So, and I had Baskin-Robbins recently. That's why I say that.
Hell yeah, dude. I don't know. I've never had a Baskin-Robbins milkshake, I don't think. So I can't really.
Oh, so good.
We grow milkshakes here in the city. I guess the only place they get them is curbside. How's Frosttop? Isn't that kind of what they're known for? Mario, you're a resident Frosttop expert. What would you say?
Oh, yeah. Frosttop is burgers and shakes. That's like its claim to fame.
Hell yeah.
Never been there.
Y'all dip the fries in the shake?
They have one on Clearview, Devin. They got one. They got several of them in New Orleans, too, I think. They have one in Destrehan.
I pass one down here all the time. I just never been in there. It always looks packed.
Do y'all dip your fries in your milkshake?
Yeah. I will.
I'm down to do that.
Yeah.
Mario?
Hell yeah.
Okay.
I mean, come on. Mario.
And Frosted.
I'm just making sure, dude.
Let's be honest here.
Danny probably doesn't. Danny, would you like to comment?
Yes, I do.
Okay. Okay. Never mind. I stand corrected. Dev, what else we got on spread lines this week?
Shout out Albert Pujols. 2 home runs.
What?
On today. Yesterday. 2.
Yeah.
How old is he?
1,000.
How's that possible?
You hit it over the fence.
I guess so.
And they won, like, I think it was like 18-4. I forget what the final score was, but I mean, everybody was having a day.
Yeah, Molina ended up pitching. Yeah, at the end of the game.
Okay, so they went full LSU this weekend. Pujols and company did. What is this? I'm intrigued. What is the Mighty Morphin Prison Ranger?
So the fella that played the red Power Ranger.
Yes, Jason, right? Or was it Rocky? No, I'm getting three ninjas confused. I think Rocky loves Emily. Well, yeah, probably my favorite martial arts movie growing up outside of Sidekicks. Sidekicks, so Three Ninjas, Surf Ninjas. But, yes, I think this guy's name was Jason, I want to say back in the day. Red Ranger was the coolest until the Green Ranger and White Ranger showed up on the scene.
Yeah, and it turns out he's been arrested on fraud, man.
Damn!
The Mighty Morphin Prison Ranger.
No.
Yeah, it turns out there was a massive, like, federal indictment involving, like, 18 people that were charged with fraud. They were part of, like, this SBA paycheck. He's a paycheck protection program.
It was a PPP thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm looking at it now. Jason Geiger arrested for PPP.
16 loans totaling 3.5 million big ones.
Damn. Come on,
Red Power Ranger goes all in when he goes all in.
Zardon would be so disappointed. What we got on the list for RB&R today, Dev?
Not sure, but we're going to probably keep it here in New Orleans.
Okay.
I'm looking at this place next to Toro Hospital. That looks good. It's a little gym-looking place. But, yeah, man, ready for a good value, ready for a big plate.
At Snow Like John with 2 N's on Twitter. Dev, anything else to let the people know before we head out today?
Just on the TV series, because I heard y'all talk about it. Yeah, Martin, man, that was a good one to bring up. And there's a reason why they still add that today, because it's such a good show.
So
you can still watch it. Pam, Tommy, Gina, Cole, Shanae.
Shanae is good.
Martin was just one of the few.
Tommy.
Yeah. Martin was one of the few that could do different, you know, impressions and make a show out of it, man. It was, man, it's just, that was awesome.
Yeah, I've never seen Martin.
Nobody shot.
Oh, my God,
But Dev.
I know.
Are you shocked?
I know. It's just like, that's TJ Maxx. I know, dude. I know.
That's what a way to end the sag, bro.
That's on me. That's a downer of an ending. I apologize for that. But that's why we'll always, what does he tell Bruce in Batman Begins? Why do we fall down? To pick ourselves back up or something? I don't know.
And then he goes to Batman Begins.
Yes, exactly. Dev, are you going to watch Obi-Wan this week?
Yeah, I'm definitely into it, bro. I'm gonna check it out for sure. Now the Top Gun 2 thing, I'm just gonna have to rewatch Top Gun 1 because it's just been a long time. I was a kid.
Yes, now is the time. Devin Snow, aka Hold the Mayo, spread lines every single Monday here at 9:15. Dev, thank you, brother.
All right, y'all take care.
Devin Snow, the main.
Oh, brother, man, on Martin, man, I'm gonna have to go watch some Martin today now.
Yeah, me too.
You could start from the beginning because you've never seen it.
We'll watch some art.
Like every character on there was perfectly cast.
Yes, out of all the infinite really pop culture that we now have on our fingertips. Where is Martin streaming? I'm sure somebody has that, right?
Somebody's got that. Yeah.
Who knows? All right, when we get back, keep it locked. More OTB.
OTB. OT. In times of need, get a full list of phone numbers, websites, and other important emergency information on the Demco Stormwatch page at 1045ESPN.com.
I've been doing business with Luba for 25 years. They're dependable, trustworthy. It's just the attention to detail with our clients.
Our folks have years and years of experience. They're highly trained professionals, but many companies have that asset. What I'd like to think makes Luba a bit different is that we use those talents in a way that truly is dedicated to serving the needs of the folks who depend on us.
Are you a licensed contractor? There's lots of good contractors in Louisiana doing work the right way, but unfortunately, too many unlicensed contractors are working outside the licensing requirements. Working as a contractor in Louisiana requires a license for the company doing the work. The Louisiana State Licensing Board for Contractors wants to help you get licensed to allow you to conduct work legally. It's not difficult to get the license. We can help you. Go to lacontractor.org for more information. Licensed contractors, it's the law.
Gulf Coast Office Products is a nationally recognized Savin office equipment dealer based right here in Louisiana. Over 100 employees strong, Gulf Coast has the boots on the ground to support all vertical markets from education, engineering, legal, and finance. With the latest in office technology from desktop to production segment units, Gulf Coast and Savin have the perfect fit for you. Call 225-756-2644. That's 756-2644 for Gulf Coast Office Products.
Service Mastery Elite create clean, disinfected work environments. As a local business, we take pride in serving the New Orleans and Baton Rouge areas. Our cleaning protocols follow CDC and OSHA standards for healthcare settings, offices, senior living, restaurants, and industrial plants. Contact Service Mastery Elite to get your operation ready for reopening with germ disinfection cleaning. Service Mastery Elite, the trusted choice in professional cleaning since 1996.
This is a house call. This is a follow-up appointment. This is a diabetes checkup. This isn't just more convenient care, it's more advanced care. This is innovating healthcare at Louisiana's number one hospital, Ochsner.
Bayou Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram has $5,000 off the new 2022 Wagoneer. We have Wagoneers in stock with $5,000 off. All new Bayou Ford vehicles come with a 1 million mile powertrain warranty. The crew at Bayou is going to do right by you.
For less. It's like he knew what he was supposed to do.
Then he did the exact opposite.
Dr. Death, starring Joshua Jackson with Christian Slater and Alec Baldwin.
I am going to fix you.
All episodes streaming now, only on Peacock.
Moscona inviting you to join us for Monday's AFR, presented by Relief Windows. We'll recap the LSU-Vandy series and the SEC tournament field will be set. We'll get you ready for Hoover. Join us, 3 to 6, 104.5 ESPN Baton Rouge.
Josie's on a vacation far away. Curve around and talk it over. So many things that I want to say. You know I like my girls a little bit older. I just want to use your love tonight. I don't want to lose your love tonight.
OTB, OT, with Hester and T-Bob on 104.5 ESPN Baton Rouge and 94.7 ESPN Alexandria.
What's up, y'all? Welcome back. OTB. Closing out the show, getting ready to do at least final 20 minutes here. Jake, you were just talking about how you have too many streaming services.
I just said I have them all, and it's just
yes, it's a lot.
You know, you have them all, so you never fail to find something to watch. But it's just like you have Hulu, you have HBO Max, yeah. You got Paramount, you got Netflix, you've got Peacock.
You have the cock, right? You have the Peacock for sure. For Premier League.
Yes.
And then what's Champions League on Paramount randomly?
I have Peacock for Premier League. Champions League's on Paramount.
HBO Max is balling.
HBO Max always got something. One. Netflix you have to have.
Yeah.
I recently got Hulu. What series did I get Hulu for?
I don't know.
I don't remember either.
Well, you know, Disney Plus had one movie kind of sneak out of nowhere that I've not finished.
Disney Plus.
So I'm not going to give it like a full-throated recommendation, but you seen the new Chip and Dale?
Knox was that. So every Wednesday night, we find a family movie and everybody piles into our room and we watch a movie on Wednesday night. And that's been the latest wreck. So we're going to watch it on Wednesday.
Yeah, it's like surprisingly, the parts that I saw were surprisingly funny.
Okay.
Got a lot of cool, like deep cuts. Got an interesting setup. Plays if you were a Chip and Dale, like if you're a Rescue Rangers kid, probably get a kick out of it. They have very early on, and I haven't seen where this goes, but they have a cameo from Ugly Sonic. Do y'all remember the Sonic that they tried to put in Sonic 1?
And they had to redo the whole thing.
And the design was so awful that they forced these animators to work 24/7 for like 8 months to redo the entire movie with a better designed Sonic with not the weird human teeth. Well, human teeth Sonic made it into, and he's one of many of these sort of details. Like I was just on the, one of my favorite subreddit is movie details on Reddit, where it's like the little things that are put in movies that you would never notice that are actually pretty cool. And there's one where like the art from Into the Spider-Verse that Miles Morales does, the graffiti is like in the background. There's Dobby, who apparently after, they live in this world, the mixture of human and animated characters. Apparently after the Harry Potter movies, like Dobby becomes a Gucci model because he's on like a Gucci ad in the back. A good job by using a lot of interesting IP in some fun ways, I would say.
That's some good Easter eggs in there, huh?
Yes, yeah, some good Easter eggs, man. Again, beginning was funny. I love the setup. I cannot tell you how it goes because I did not watch the rest of it. Mack Lindsey, though, the new Chip and Dale movie was a really fun watch. There we go. If anybody's looking for something to watch for your kids, maybe go check it out.
We got that Wednesday. We can't worry about that today, though, T-Bob, because we've got playoff baseball. For the Hester crew, okay?
Okay, yes, we got to lock in.
We got three, possibly four games.
Okay.
So we got to and there's an, I don't know if it's tonight, but I think it is. If we win, we're probably looking at Memphis going against Jetpack.
Oh, wow, against the Jetpack Don himself.
Mm-hmm.
Someone very famously that is willing to do whatever it takes in order to win. All I'm saying is watch out for Memphis's knees. You may be hitting a little Tanya Harding situation. Yeah, Memphis is going to be walking through. Is he still in school this week?
No.
Oh, okay. Nah, okay, so he's safe.
I don't go to school during playoff baseball.
So he's safe. Then he doesn't have to. Then he doesn't have to walk the halls and get his kneecaps taken.
Yeah.
Out.
Okay. Yeah. And we're gonna keep him home. We're gonna keep him safe.
Just watch him at the park.
Yeah.
Watch him at the park because Jetpack's probably got some agents sneaking around looking to take him out of the first opportunity that they get.
Yeah. So we'll see. We'll see. I'm going to miss the first 20 minutes of the game, but be coming in hot, straight off air. Hopefully in those 20 minutes, both the teams are up.
Yeah, hopefully it's not like the game's already decided and you just roll into miserable one way or another. Yeah. Love on the Spectrum is pretty good, by the way, too. They just came out with Love on the Spectrum USA. If you're looking for a good, enjoyable, kind of mindless show to watch that's going to uplift you a little bit, maybe make you cry a little bit, I would say check that out.
Oh, dang, I have Amazon Prime, too. My God, I need to rethink my life.
I know, bro.
And,
what are we gonna
do? DirecTV Stream.
What are we gonna
do? That's one thing probably I need to get rid of.
Yeah, so just do, well.
Because I don't watch anything on TV.
Except for sports.
Yeah, but I could just do the ESPN package.
That's why that Hulu ESPN Plus bundle isn't bad.
Yeah, but then you don't get, like, live CBS TV. And you don't get Fox.
If you do the Hulu Live, you do.
Yeah, but it's the same thing, though. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah. It's the
same thing.
You would not be saving. Yeah, you would not be saving.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
You would save maybe like $5 or $10 or something. It's not going to be anything extreme.
Well, the only time I actually watch like cable is like Sundays after the Premier League. I'm like, all right, what's on? And that's how I watched Jumper yesterday.
Yeah, I don't know when the last time I watched cable was, man. I randomly turned on cable the other day, and my wife was like, are you watching a live television show right now?
Yeah.
And I was like, yeah, I guess I am. And then we went to the first commercial break, and I changed it. So I apologize. I know you all sit through commercials with us every single morning. Shout out to all of our wonderful sponsors, how we do this show. Real quick, to honor the rundown here, 2019 LSU, Jeff Duncan has a piece of Times Tribune. If you want to read about it, go check it out. All it is just about now that we're three drafts away from that national championship team, it's just pointing out how absurd that team was. 30 players have been drafted, 7 first-round picks, 8 day 2 selections, 8 other players have made teams as UDFAs. During minicamp, 38 of the 53 players that played a snap in the Natty will be on NFL rosters. 21 of the 22 starters on that team are on NFL rosters. Joe Burrow, comeback player of the year. Jamar Chase, rookie of the year. Jets, second and rookie of the year. 12 starters in the NFL. 8 starters from offense. It's just ridiculous.
Who's the starter that's not in the NFL? Adrian McGee.
Yep. Yes. Yep. Adrian McGee, and that was off the roof. That was impressive. Adrian McGee and somebody else. Zach Von Rosenberg would be the starters who are not. So Adrian McGee would be out of the 22, and Von Rosenberg, yeah, the specialist, wow, not in there. Which, I mean, is
even the kicker, the deep snapper.
Yes, which is very rare.
Okay, they actually both got drafted.
Which is even rarer.
I mean.
How about this, though? So what this does bring up, as you talk about the greatest teams of all time, do you know how many first-round picks 2001 Miami had? First round. I did not realize this. First round picks 2001 Miami had. And this is why people still fear the specter of the U, regardless of fan buying and everything else. I don't think you're going to get this number. 11. Have you read it on here?
No, 11.
Anybody else want to guess?
I'll go 8.
Daniel?
15.
Danny's the closest. 17 first-round picks of the 2001 Miami team, including potentially 3 Hall of Famers. Ed Reed, Andre Johnson, and Frank Gore were all on that team. Oh, my God, dude. 17 first-round picks. So, I mean, and LSU was great. 38 players drafted as well. So LSU was great, and even still, they're just a little bit under from an NFL standpoint. Right. I think they probably, you know, who would win the game is a different conversation. But
you know what the difference is?
The quarterback.
Ken Dorsey versus,
yes,
Joe Burrow.
Exactly, which is why I would take LSU in a, yeah, game, but 17 first-round, yeah, picks has got to be, yeah, the greatest roster ever.
Those uniforms, too, were so great. Like now they'd be dated, but at the time, remember how cool those uniforms were? Like every high school, yeah, went to like that font. And
I know,
like,
and it's so ugly now.
It's so bad now, but at the time. And Ed Reed's shoulder pads, I swear, they were like 6 inches up on his like helmet. They were so big, and he looked terrifying.
All right, when we get back here, let's close out with a little Ask the Bench.
Sweet uniform back then.
Cole Kurzweil, Busy Art Tilted, Blue Moon Lot Sky, Citrus Sweet coming up next.
OTB, OT.
Go to All-Star Toyota of Baton Rouge.com. All-Star Toyota of Baton Rouge.com. We were talking about it earlier in the day, but my God, y'all. I got to rent that 2022 Sienna for the weekend because my car was in the shop. Shout out Tommy Wagenspack. Get me in and out. Both cars actually over there at All-Star right now, Jake. But yeah, so whatever. They got me right over the weekend, but then they gave us a rental at 2020 Sienna, and it is amazing. If you are making the minivan plunge, there has quite literally never been a better time than right now. So take the plunge. Join me in the MVG, the minivan gang. We rolling deep, okay? Over there at All-Star Toyota Baton Rouge.
Now is the time. If your children aren't already out of school, this is going to be the last week. So you probably got a vacation coming up this weekend. You got a holiday coming up next Monday. So you're probably thinking, okay, we need something bigger. Like, we need more room. We need more room for passengers, for whatever we've got, luggage. All-Star Toyota of BatonRouge.com. Rent it today.
Our listeners fire off their opinions on the JimsFirearms.net hotline at 499-1045. Keep listening for your next chance to shoot us your thoughts with the JimsFirearms.net hotline on 1045 ESPN Baton Rouge.
There it is, the extra mile. On the border of expected and extraordinary for those willing to go further, like vans customized for work or play. With safety and tech to keep you connected. Supported by a 5-star sales service and finance team. And backed by the 1-star you know. So go the extra mile. It's never crowded because so few have what it takes to go there. Mercedes-Benz vans.
Join 100.7 The Tiger and Our Lady of the Lake Ascension Saturday, June 25th at the Lamar Dixon Expo Center in Gonzales.
Enjoy live music from Ted Durr, Mike Broussard and the Night Train, and Jamie Badron and the Kickin' Cajuns. Make sure you grab a delicious plate of jambalaya from the Mike Ward's Liberty Safe's Jambalaya Cook-Off to raise money for the Alzheimer's services of the capital area.
The Swamp Pop Music Festival with Supreme Chevrolet.
Louisiana's Country Station.
100.7 The Tiger.
I've been doing business with Luba for 25 years. They're dependable, trustworthy. It's just the attention to detail with our clients.
Our folks have years and years of experience. They're highly trained professionals. But many companies have that asset. What I'd like to think makes Luba a bit different is that we use those talents in a way that truly is dedicated to serving the needs of the folks who depend on us.
Crime has serious consequences, but anyone can make a mistake. If you find yourself in trouble with the law, know that you have rights, and it's okay to demand them. The law offices of O.C. Brown are here to protect you and your rights. Felony or misdemeanor, DUI or drug charge, no matter what crime you're accused of, you still have rights. Let the law offices of O.C. Brown uphold them. Call 225-343-1111, your law firm for a lifetime.
It's no secret, the best oysters in Baton Rouge are at Jolie Pearl Oyster Bar. Enjoy mouth-watering South Louisiana flavor and oysters from all over the country. And don't forget our nightly drink specials. Jolie Pearl Oyster Bar, located in downtown Baton Rouge.
Eli's always been into grilling. It took us a while to see it, but the signs were there.
What are you doing, Eli?
I knew grilling was my thing. I have been talking about it throughout my career.
Happy with the results?
I am. Got the new grill from barbecueguys.com. It performed great.
My advice, as I always told my boys,
do more of what you're born to do.
Barbecue Guys, for those who are born to grill.
Edition of Hunt and Hill. Get the recap from LSU and Vanderbilt. Where's LSU's NCAA tournament resume? And we'll get you ready for Hoover. Hunt and Hill, noon to two weekdays on 104.5 ESPN, Baton Rouge.
OTB OT with Hester and T-Bob on 104.5 ESPN Baton Rouge and 94.7 ESPN Alexandria.
Welcome back to OTB. Two things real quick. Shout out to my guy, the Jetpack Don, texting me, telling me it is Jackson Hayes' birthday today. Happy B-Day, Jackson Hayes. Jackson Hayes is just 22 years old.
I mean, Jetpack can't text me in a group text because we might. Okay. Oh, okay. Wow. Taking it that, okay.
Bro, it feels like Jackson Hayes been in the league forever. I mean, he has, right? This is going to be year number four next year, and he's 22.
First ask the bench question. If you could only keep one for the Pelicans, Larry Nance or Jackson Hayes?
Larry Nance.
Still got to be Jackson Hayes, right?
I think Larry right now is a better player, but Jackson ultimately has a higher ceiling.
Yeah.
I'd also say Jackson, but I would see why I see Larry.
I like them both.
Is there risk?
But I got Larry Nance's mentality.
Look, Scary Larry was so good in the playoffs. He's got funny memes. He's embraced the city. I love Larry. I do not want this to come off as anything else.
He refs the Pelicans so hard on Twitter.
Yes, that's what I'm saying.
Hasn't even signed yet.
He's about it. About it. This comes from my buddy Marty, who found on Tiger Droppings. I didn't realize this. The game... Oh, never mind. I just read it, and I don't think it's as interesting. Oh, wait, no, it is. It is. My bad. So the game went from – no, I misread it the second time I was reading it. The Vanderbilt game was 9-7, right?
Yeah.
And then we all know the incredible run that happened. What I did not quite realize, that run only took 7 pitches. So it went from 9-7 to 14-9 on 7 pitches. That's pretty cool. That's a fun little quirk. That's a pretty good average, one run per pitch.
Mm-hmm.
I would say.
That dog a hunt.
Ask the Bench, brought to you by Cole Kerslake, Vizier, Toast, Blue Moon Lights, Guys, Citrus, Sweet. Danny, can we get a plane with the boys to rejoin this weekend on our Top Gun?
We should, Thursday, Danny, should be.
This is the first time I'm hearing of that request.
No, it's not.
No,
chill
out. Danny, shut up.
Thursday should be all Top Gun rejoins. The soundtrack of Top Gun. I think we could.
Yeah, absolutely. I'm down. Hashtag ask the bench. Could a person survive if he was falling in an elevator and they jumped as it hit the ground? I mean, in theory, if you could jump hard enough, I just don't think you'd be able to jump hard enough. But in theory, if you could, right?
Yeah.
But I don't know if you can come up with enough force to counteract a gravity free fall. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You're like, even jumping, I think you still have too much momentum.
And then you, you know what? I really don't want to find out.
No. Don't ride in this elevator.
OTB. OT.
Y'all have an excellent day. We love you. Also want to remind you to go to AgTemp and AgTempBR.com and go to GoTro'sOutdoorPower.com. We love our local companies here, and GoTro's Outdoor Power is local, family owned. All of your heavy equipment needs right there at GoTro's. And look, we are statewide here on OTB. And guess where GoTro's delivers when you buy from them? Statewide, okay? We unite the clans here on OTB, North and South Louisiana, and GoTro's agrees with that. So buy from them, get free delivery anywhere in the state, get full access to both the parts and service departments. GoTro'sOutdoorPower.com.
They're real Danny McBride vibes from there statewide. I think we need to make that a thing. We can definitely do that. GoTro'sOutdoorPower.com. They always say, like, we make it easy. Multiple things they can make easy. Free delivery in the state. Baton Rouge Gonzales, they got showrooms set up for success. Walk in, tell them what you're looking for. They will find a way to get it to you. GoTro'sOutdoorPower.com. We make it easy.
Come on over to Corval Toyota to pre-order your next vehicle. It's an easy and stress-free process. Browse, reserve, pick up, and enjoy. It's that simple. So come on down to Happy Town. That's Corval Toyota in Opelousas, Happy Town, USA.
The 2022 Smoke 'Em If You Got 'Em, presented by Mockler Beverage, is almost here. Smoke 'Em If You Got 'Em is an event that raises money to support military veterans and their families. Tickets are $100, and this year's event benefits the Special Forces Charitable Trust. Come enjoy live music, a grill station, a cigar station, a dessert station, a live and silent auction, and so much more. It's the 2022 Smoke 'Em If You Got 'Em fundraiser, presented by Mockler Beverage, Sunday, May 22nd at Ben 77. Learn more at smokeembr.com.
Dibs! Dibs! Dibs!
Kids have staked out their place at Ochsner Medical Complex, The Grove, where more than 30 pediatricians and pediatric specialists are all conveniently located under one roof, so you can spend less time driving and more time keeping your kids well.
Dibs!
It's no wonder kids call dibs at The Grove. Ochsner Health Center for Children.
Gulf Coast Bank and Trust is giving our customers the power.